a month to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Lock it here for more live content. Free Talk Live is next on the Liberty Radio Network. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.fm.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, September 5th, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,265, silver opened at $19.10, and Bitcoin is trading around $484.38. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. Vote Michael Cargill to get the cars moving. Learn more or sign up to volunteer at CargillForTexas.com. This political advertisement paid for by the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. In the news today, on Thursday, U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder announced the federal government is launching a second investigation into the Ferguson, Missouri Police Department. The focus will be on who the officers stop and search, how suspects are treated in jail, and the department's officer training. The investigation will be handled by the Justice Department Civil Rights Division. The news comes after weeks of protests following the police shooting of 18-year-old Michael Brown. Jacob Lavoro, the 19-year-old man arrested in Williamson County, Texas, for possessing and selling pot brownies, received his trial date this week. Lavoro was originally facing life in prison, but the first-degree felony charges associated with his case were dropped, quite possibly due to the massive outcry from local and national activists and supporters. Justin Armand, executive director of Texans for Accountable Government, is one such supporter. He was present during the court proceedings and told the Liberty Beat that Jacob needs public support as he still faces charges that could carry up to 20 years in prison. Justin called Lavoro a peaceful young man who would be considered an entrepreneur in Colorado. Lavoro's court date has been set for December 1st, with a pretrial date set for November 12th at 1:30. At the pretrial hearing, Lavoro's attorney will present a motion to suppress certain evidence on the grounds that police entered his home illegally. The Liberty Beat will keep you up to date as this story unfolds. San Antonio Police Chief William McManus received support from the City Council Public Safety Committee this week when he presented a proposal, first revealed by News Radio WOAI, to ticket motorists who give money to street corner panhandlers. McManus told the committee there are alternative ways to give, as money given on the street, quote, goes for drugs and goes for alcohol. McManus said he would make a formal presentation on his plan next month. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, all-natural teeth whitener. Go to MyMagicMud.com to hear a short interview with Dr. Griffin Cole. That's MyMagicMud.com. And the Liberty Beat is brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for all things Bitcoin. Now hosting a Bitcoin ATM in Austin, Texas, 1904 Guadalupe Street, or online, BraveNewBookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, September 5th, 2014. Check out the website at TheLibertyBeat.com. And like us on Facebook, Facebook.com, TheLibertyBeat. Several media outlets have reported on 11 planes allegedly missing from a Libyan airport and the possibility that the planes could be used for a terror attack. The Washington Free Beacon, Al Jazeera Television, and USA Today have reported that intelligence agencies believe the jets could be used to strike targets on the 13th anniversary of the 9/11 attacks. A spokeswoman for the White House National Security Council told USA Today there's no confirmation that aircraft were stolen. Pictures are available online that purport to show Islamic militants standing with planes they allegedly took from an airport in Tripoli. The Huffington Post also reported that a Moroccan military expert claimed there was credible intelligence for the planes to be used in an attack on the 9/11 anniversary. Duke University and New York University have recently begun offering courses on cryptocurrencies. NYU professor Jeffrey Miller and professor David Yermak are teaching the law and business of Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies. Yermak stated the course will teach how cryptocurrencies affect the principles of finance. In the spring of 2015, Duke University finance professor Campbell Harvey will begin teaching innovation, disruption, and crypto ventures, focusing on the potential of blockchain technology. cryptocurrency courses already offered at the University of Nicosia in Cyprus and the UK's University of Cumbria. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. And support comes from Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Incorporated, specializing in precious metals since 1977. Now accepting Bitcoin. Online, rrbi.co, or by phone, 800-874-9760. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, September 5th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Following reports of a newly posted job listing at area marketing firm Swenson Digital, The Onion spoke to a few of the 1,400 applicants who claim they are, quote, absolutely perfect for this position.
When I first saw this opening, I knew it was right for me. I've got tons of experience. I've got all the skills they're looking for.
If you look at my resume, I've got everything they're looking for. I mean, I've held similar jobs like this in the past. I'm extremely driven. I really think this is going to work out.
I've got a BA in marketing, which the posting said was recommended, so I think that'll bode really well for me. I've had plenty of team experience, and I think that would stand out. Not to mention the fact that I'm great with
web design and HTML, and pretty proficient with Excel and PowerPoint. Also, I think the culture is
very me, you know? I think I'd fit in well with the other employees. I also think I had a great resume
and cover letter. I think as soon as they interview me, they'll see I'm the perfect candidate.
As of this video's release, Swenson Digital had extended a job offer to an applicant who happens to be a friend of the boss's son.
This is the Onion News Network.
Talk Live, and you are invited here to take control of the airwaves. All you have to do is dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online. Go to freetalklive.com and enjoy the features waiting for you on the site. Tonight, got an attack hit piece from Salon.com. They apparently are obsessed with libertarians, and they've been writing a lot about libertarians over at Salon, and we have the 7 strangest, according to them, libertarian ideas. So we'll share some of those with you, maybe scatter them throughout the show as we get around to them, because it's just, I don't know if we want to run through them all at once. We'll also take your calls about whatever's on your mind. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. We have Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. With you in the studio, Ian here.
Ellen.
And Daryl.
All right, so Ellen is here with us, and she's got an update, actually, on a story that we covered previously on the show, although I don't know, I don't think you were here for it, Ellen. You just saw this story in you're doing your show prep, and you thought you found it interesting.
Right. I just stumbled upon this, actually, on Reuters.com. You say it like Reuters, right?
Reuters, yeah.
Reuters,
yeah.
Okay. And for some reason, I thought it was Reuters.
It does look that way, or like Reuters, or something. Maybe, Reuters. Or do they pronounce it Reuters?
Reuters.
Reuters, okay. See, who knows? But
Daryl knows.
This thing, this guy, his name is Charlie Shrem. He's actually a former advertiser with Free Talk Live.
Oh, wow.
Bit Instant was his company, and we had Bit Instant on board here for many months on Free Talk Live before things kind of went south with the company, and that's a whole other story. And then there's these criminal charges that he got, you know, he picked up. And that's, again, it's a crazy situation where he was basically just trying to help somebody get some Bitcoin. But apparently there's all these rules that the government wants you to follow about identifying people. And they claim that he wasn't following those rules. That's kind of a short version of the indictment, which was, you know, multiple pages. And I did take a look through the actual indictment, where they apparently one of the reasons why Charlie got caught was because he was not encrypting his conversation. So when he was doing business, when he was talking about the things that he was doing with others and with the person in question, he was just using straight up unencrypted emails. So it was not hard at all for the feds to do the investigation of this matter and take him down.
So the feds were just following after this man because they thought he looked suspicious?
Oh, God, I forget. It's been a long while since I read the indictment. I forget what it was that tipped them off to, you know, to start investigating him.
So I can't answer that question right now. But share the update with us. What's going on? Okay. And where is it from?
Well, it's actually a very sad story to me from Reuters.com. Bitcoin promoter pleads guilty to unlicensed use of currency. And it shows a picture of him walking out of the federal court in Lower Manhattan on the 4th. Okay, so that was yesterday. Mm-hmm. This is very recent. A man who helped to promote Bitcoin wants to remain in the business despite pleading guilty Thursday to indirectly helping send more than $1 million in the digital currency to users of the illicit online marketplace Silk Road, his lawyer says. So right out the bat, they're making it sound, you know, just like the worst crime ever, because this illicit
Drug dealers.
This is like the real Silk Road, you know, where all the black market deals go down and all the scum of the earth just gather there. Like, that's what it sounds like to me. And you can tell that this is already biased.
Absolutely. It's hard to get the mainstream media to be, you know, to give the Silk Road a fair shake. That's just not going to happen. We'll do it here on Free Talk Live because, well, I understand the Silk Road and I understand how it brings so much safety to the underground black marketplace. And I think, to me, the people operating the Silk Road and the people running within the Silk Road are, in a lot of cases, heroes. Now, there are scam artists on the Silk Road as well, but the people running the service are doing some amazing work.
Right, just because it's based on total free market principles. And there's a lot more that goes on there than just drug use. And
that's true.
I think you could
buy books on the Silk Road.
Yeah, it's helpful. I think it, you know, teaches people how to better deal with one another. But, you know, I guess not everyone shares that opinion.
All right, so tell me more about what happened with Charlie Shrem. So he walked out of court yesterday.
Charlie Shrem, 24, pleaded guilty at a hearing in New York federal court to one count of aiding and abetting an unlicensed money transmitting business. A co-conspirator, Robert Fayella, 54, separately pleaded guilty to operating such a business. Both men face up to 5 years in prison when they appear again in court in January.
Oh.
I knew that much of the business on Silk Road involved the buying and selling of narcotics, Shrem said in court. I knew that what I was doing was wrong. See, that's the sad part to me, is that he said that he thought he was doing something wrong.
Yeah, I totally agree with your assessment on this, Ellen. That it's obviously not wrong to exchange one currency for another for your customers, regardless of whatever the purpose of the customer is. And in this case, he did know that he was dealing with somebody who was doing business on the Silk Road. And I think the other guy you mentioned, Robert Fayella, anyway, that guy was the other person in this matter, and he was essentially offering a cash exchange. So he wasn't doing drug sales. He was on the Silk Road offering to exchange cash for Bitcoin for people.
Right, and it's ridiculous to think that he's responsible for what happens to whatever he's selling or buying after the transaction happens.
Hold on. So based on the allegations, as I'm hearing them against Charlie Shrem and the other guy, then would not every one of the check cashing services across the country be guilty of this? Because they're generally used by low-income people that live in bad neighborhoods that may or may not light things on fire that affect their brain.
There's a good chance that someone walking into a check cashing service to get cash out for the weekend is going to go spend that on drugs.
More
there's
likely
a good chance
than not, right?
Yeah. Whether the drugs are legal or illegal is another question, and I imagine there's a good mix of that.
Right, but so if they're going after Bitcoin because people are using Bitcoin to buy drugs, well, people are using dollars to buy drugs too.
That's what they've been using for generations.
Well, that's the thing about this, is that ultimately Shrem wasn't funding drug sales directly, and it's presumed, you know, the feds are presuming that he was, you know, that the money going into the Silk Road was ultimately going to buy drugs. Again, you can go and buy legal stuff on the Silk Road. Anyone can put any kind of product up. Yes, it's true. There are lots of drug entries there. Yes,
this
there are fake IDs.
This is based on a lot of hypothetical assumptions, though.
Well, but that's just it. They're not charging him with conspiracy to commit drug sales, and they're not charging him with conspiracy to money launder. They're like they are with some of the operators or the alleged operators of the Silk Road. They're charging him with running an unlicensed money transmitting business, correct? That was what he pled guilty to.
Right.
So by that charge, they've got him by the balls.
Legally, I mean, that one makes direct
sense. It's a stupid charge.
It is.
It shouldn't exist. And this money, all these money transmitter laws, which money transmitter is a legal term and it's got a definition that's very nebulous, but all these money transmitter laws are in existence because of the war on drugs, essentially, because, you know, they want to supposedly stop money laundering. These are some of the reasons for the Know Your Customer legislation and stuff like that. A lot of that was pushed by the war on drugs.
Actually, the Know Your Customer stuff came about because of the USA Patriot Act, because we got to make sure that the banks aren't funding terrorists.
Hmm. Yeah, well, isn't it kind of useful for the government if there's a black market that exists? Because if they allow like major and small transactions to coexist like on the black market level, but then only go after a few of the major transactions, but allow the, you know, the basis for the black market to stay alive, then they've got something to keep them busy all the time.
They sure do.
So it's kind of like in prison when they keister things and there's a whole business going on.
What's a keister?
In and out of the prison. So I heard this when I was on Puke in the Gang last week. The hobo that was guest starring on the show told us prison stories, and he was saying that keistering was when, you know, prisoners hide something in their anus and they take it into prison. And there's a lot of going on in and out of the prison with these trustees who work, you know, who do community service kind of stuff.
Right. Yep, it's true. That's one of the more effective ways to get things in and out of a prison. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE. I just hadn't heard that term before. 855-450-3733. And Daryl, you used to work in a prison. Had you heard that one?
I had not, but I knew what she was talking about.
More coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
This is Mark Edge of Free Talk Live, and I've got something awesome to share with you. I've recently joined Liberty.me. It's an online city devoted to people who love liberty. Break free of the flame wars and bridge-dwelling denizens of Facebook. You deserve better. You deserve a friendly, ad-free social network where you can chat 24 hours a day with like-minded souls around the world. Attend live interactive classes with experts on economics, finance, politics, and money. Access a vast library of books and discuss them with your reading group. Better your life with exclusive self-help guides on investing, self-defense, homeschooling, security, healthcare, saving money, and starting a business. Become a libertarian luminary yourself and get paid in the process by publishing your works on Liberty.me. Get tipped via PayPal and Bitcoin.
The first step towards freedom is to invest in yourself. Start your free 30-day trial now at Liberty.me.
I love being a member of Liberty.me, and I think you will too. The first month is free. Sign up and say hello.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
Free Talk Live.
When a deer approaches a marijuana plant in the woods and nibbles off one of the buds, is that sad? Is that deer living a sad state of existence?
I have no idea. I've never heard of an animal eating something
but
that would
Christy,
make them,
that's because you
know,
have no idea what you're talking about. You don't know
one thing
about cannabis. You don't know anything about it.
I understand that you want to partake of that drug.
Oh,
and
I do. Trust
but
me.
Listen, I understand that you should have the right to do that.
Well, thank you.
Where it's legal.
Since the beginning of time, human beings and other animals have been altering their state of consciousness. Believe it or not, it's not just a human being thing.
Robins eat elderberries in the fall and get drunk on them.
Yes, so this is a common thing amongst the various different creatures of this earth.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938. 877-357-9938.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. We're here to take your calls about whatever's on your mind. Though, talking about the sentencing of, or what would be at some point the sentencing of Charlie Shrem. There's some kind of a plea deal involved, but there's also a sentencing still that has to happen. We'll get into that here in a moment. He is charged with running an illegal money transmitting business, an unlicensed money transmitting business, trying to give people bitcoins in return for cash. And so they've come after him for that, and I'm sure that the feds are hoping this is going to be a scary thing for other people that are doing business with Bitcoin to try to scare them off. We'll get back into that here in a moment. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. If you'd like to comment, you can join us on Skype as well. Skype username is lrn.fm. And we were talking a moment ago about the Silk Road. Shrem himself was not doing sales on the Silk Road. He was not selling drugs, but he was selling Bitcoin to someone who was selling Bitcoin on the Silk Road, or rather selling cash, I think, on the Silk Road. And I think that was how it was working. Please correct me if I'm wrong. I haven't read the indictment in 6 months. And the Silk Road's an amazing thing. It is a black marketplace for the internet. And there are other ones now. In fact, I was just reading an article about Agora Marketplace, which has become bigger than the Silk Road. There's now Silk Road 2.0, and Agora Marketplace has more listings than the Silk Road does.
How recent is this?
I just saw this headline literally within the last 48 hours, so I don't know when the story was written, but I suspect it's fairly recent. But Silk Road's still going strong. It's not to say Silk Road's doing poorly. Silk Road was shut down in October of last year.
Right. I'm just shocked that I haven't heard this name more often, though.
Agora Marketplace?
Yes.
It's worth looking at. It's a nice looking site. They've done a good job with it. And they came out after the Silk Road was taken down. So when Silk Road went down, there were these other ones that popped up. Some of them turned out to be scams. So far, the Agora Marketplace hasn't taken everybody's money and run yet. But it's, you know, it's always interesting to watch the way these things play out. So Silk Road got taken down by the FBI.
Right, because people were fearing things like that. Like somebody was going to take the money and run.
Well, that's not why Silk Road was taken down. Silk Road was taken down by the feds because they want to stop the drug trade. Or at least that's the supposed story. In this case, we all know that they're not going to stop the drug trade. And in point of fact, if you let Silk Road continue, it will actually reduce the violence involved in the drug trade. Because on the Silk Road, no one knows anyone else.
Right. There's no face-to-face interaction.
Ever.
So there's no chance of like a knife fight in
you can't
an alley
be robbed.
Or something.
That's correct. You cannot be robbed, at least in person. You can't have a gun or a knife held to you. You can't be beaten physically. None of that stuff happens on the Silk Road. You can still get ripped off. There's still some people that will offer a product and then they will not deliver that product. And so there's problems. You know, nothing's perfect. But it certainly is a major improvement. So they took the Silk Road down in October, and then the Silk Road came back a month later. So they didn't really do much of anything to stop the online drug marketplace. But they have charged some guys, some males criminally. Four guys were arrested last year. One of them, Ross Ulbricht, alleged to be the founder of the Silk Road, a.k.a. Dread Pirate Roberts. He's been facing some pretty serious charges, including conspiracy to commit money laundering, conspiracy to deal drugs, conspiracy to hack, because on the Silk Road there were hacking tools available for sale as well as drugs. And they're also charging him with a kingpin statute. Ross has gotten a lot of publicity for this. I'm sure he could use some more, so you can go to freeross.org to help him out with his defense, because he doesn't have any of the money, because they seized all of what appear to be all of his bitcoins. And if he does have more bitcoins, he certainly can't access them from inside a federal prison cell. Andrew Jones is another one of the alleged operators of the Silk Road. He's facing similar charges as Ross Ulbricht, but hasn't gotten near as much press coverage. So not as many people know even what his name is. His name is Andrew Michael Jones. He's a Free State Project participant, and the federal government is alleging that he is one of the administrators of the Silk Road, was one of the administrators, named Inigo. He needs help too, and you can go and give him some assistance at drewsdefense.org. That's drewsdefense.org. Now, Ellen, you're telling us about Charlie Schrem. Schrem is a businessman. He's fairly young. You said he's 24 years old now.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And I've known him for a couple of years. So when he was running BitInstant, he was probably, you know, his earlier 20s, 22 years old or something like that. And he just, not necessarily suggesting that age would have brought this wisdom, experience does. And he didn't encrypt any of the critical messages that he was sending about the business that he was doing, which was exchanging Bitcoin for cash, and or rather exchanging cash for Bitcoin. And that's what they've come after him for. So go ahead and continue with the story.
Right. So this is where it gets to the what I find to be ironic part, which is his lawyer, Mark Agnifilo, said that what Schrem did was an aberration and that Schrem plans to continue working in the Bitcoin world if possible. So he wants to get back into Bitcoin again someday after all of these charges have passed.
Mm-hmm.
Agnifilo emphasized that his client was not involved in directly supplying Bitcoin to Silk Road users. We believe... Oh, shoot, sorry. The page jumped.
Oh, no.
I just lost my sentence. That happens.
So, he wasn't directly involved in sending money to the Silk Road's buyers. He was sending them to one of their users. He was sending Bitcoin, rather, to one of their users, who was then, from what I understand, operating a cash in exchange for Bitcoin service. So people could send Bitcoin to him through the Silk Road, and he would send cash through the mail, from what I understand. Did you find your place?
Right. Okay. Yes, I've got it. So the two pleaded guilty as part of a deal struck with prosecutors from the office of Manhattan U.S. Attorney Preet Bharara. They had been scheduled to go on trial September 22nd. U.S. authorities shut down Silk Road last year, though a new version bearing the same name was launched soon thereafter, like you were saying, Ian. The man accused of creating and operating Silk Road used the alias Dread Pirate Roberts, Ross William Ulbricht, is facing separate charges and is scheduled for trial in November. Schrem stepped down from his post as vice chairman of the Bitcoin Foundation, mm-hmm. a trade group, soon after his arrest in January. He was previously the chief executive of BitInstant, a Bitcoin exchange company. So I remember hearing the name of this company a lot, like when I first moved here.
Yeah, well, that's because they were one of the best. They were probably the best option for a long time for exchanging cash for Bitcoin. They don't exist anymore, and they haven't for quite a while, except mm-hmm. probably at least a year at this point. But they did it, and they did a good job of it. And the problem was, as time went on, they became more compliant. No, that's not the problem for them. They had to do it in order to keep doing business legally. They were based out of New York, and of course, as we've seen recently, New York has had some of the worst regulatory pushes for regulating Bitcoin. And so they had to keep increasing the level of requirements as far as you had to show identification. You didn't used to have to show identification to get a transaction done. You would have had to have provided some ID eventually as time went on. And so they were kind of clamping down. But behind the scenes, Charlie Schrem was doing business directly with this individual sort of outside of the BitInstant system. Still kind of using BitInstant, but Charlie was using his sway with the business to kind of make the requirements go away for this guy, whereas all the rest of us, if we were doing that level of business, would have had to provide some ID and some regular identification.
He was like a co-conspirator.
He basically was helping this guy get around the money transmitting laws and regulations, and so that's why they got him for it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We'll come back with more. And Bitcoin, I don't think we've mentioned this. It's a decentralized currency. We can tell you more about that coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
Attention all listeners, are you ready for a free stock market webinar with PhilsGang.com? Join us September 13th at 12 noon Eastern for this live PhilsGang.com free webinar, valued at $75. You'll learn how to protect your principal in this Federal Reserve-controlled low-interest rate market by identifying moves before they happen. To register, simply go to LearnStocksForFree.com. LearnStocksForFree.com. Or call 877-600-4264, promo code GCN. 877-600-4264, promo code GCN.
Listen, you've heard the commercials before. Whether you owe $15,000 or $15 million in tax debt to the IRS or state, we can help. On a never-ending payment plan? Penalties and interest killing you? Missing tax returns? Being garnished or levied? Not a problem. If you qualify, we can remove levies and garnishments within days or even hours of hiring our firm. If you've been summoned, or even worse, receiving tax warrants in the mail, call right now. Are you a business owner with back payroll taxes? Is the IRS or state threatening to close your business you've worked so hard to build? Protect yourself and your business. Even if you've tried in the past, new guidelines could potentially qualify you today. So what are you waiting for? We can take that tax monkey off your back.
Call the Tax Monkey now. 800-281-6030. 800-281-6030. 800-281-6030. That's 800-281-6030.
Imagine for a moment a radio program, the most personal of mediums, that reaches hundreds of thousands of people on more than 140 radio stations across the U.S. and around the world through the internet with podcasts and live streams. Imagine the advertising is affordable from $600 to $6,000 a month. Free Talk Live is that program. We will work with you to get clicks, calls, views, or sales. Email me at mark@freetalklive.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more.
It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement, and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary at fpp.cc, as well as weekly news in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com. The monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc and books at shop.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here at 855-450-FREE, whether you want to talk about the Bitcoin scene, whatever aspect of it. Bitcoin is a decentralized currency that was created by no bank or government, and you can actually go and get them very easily. We were talking about one of the companies that had existed previously to assist you in that purpose. They don't exist anymore. But ExpressCoin.com is great, and they've been doing amazing work, and they are fully licensed and all that. You know, they follow the money transmitter rules, etc. So if you want to get Bitcoins quickly, or Dogecoin, Litecoin, Blackcoin, Darkcoin, those are all available through ExpressCoin.com. You go there, and it's easy to get started over there. So easy to set up an account, and you can even grab their smartphone app. They also do it very affordably, so you can take advantage of a special deal by using code FTL to get up to $40 worth, $40 worth of Bitcoin or any of those other altcoins for no fee. So to pay no fee to transfer money from one form into another is an amazing deal, and they're doing that over at ExpressCoin.com. Now, if you go above $40, then it's only a 3% transfer fee, which is, again, also an amazing price. I've never seen a better price for a Bitcoin exchange anywhere. So check it out at expresscoin.com. And by the way, it's now available in Canada. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Ellen, you've got a little bit more on this story about Charlie Shrem. He's the former operator of BitInstant, and he was doing some sort of behind-the-scenes deals, although he unfortunately did not encrypt his communications about those behind-the-scenes deals. And so the feds were easily able to get into his email account and gather all kinds of evidence against him that he wasn't indeed following the rules, so to speak, these money transmitter rules that his company at the time, BitInstant, was supposed to be following. And so because he was sort of working around those and giving this one guy a special treatment, they came after him and they came after the guy. The guy's name was Robert, and they both now have taken a guilty plea.
Right. According to this article from Reuters, prosecutors said Fayella, 54, operated an underground Bitcoin exchange on Silk Road under the name BTC King, providing currency for users engaged in illicit drug trafficking.
Mm-hmm.
Shrem processed transactions for Fayella through BitInstant, despite knowing the Bitcoin would eventually find their way to Silk Road, where the funds would be used for drugs, he said in court. Both men agreed to forfeit $950,000 to the government as part of their plea deals. Robert Fayella and Charlie Shrem opted to travel down a crooked path, running an illegal money transmitting business that catered to criminals bent on trafficking narcotics on the dark web drug site Silk Road, Barrara said in a statement.
This was the U.S. attorney who was speaking there. This is their prosecutor who was making that statement. And okay, that's it. Well, you've shut down the underground drug market now. That you can pat yourself on the back and act like you've actually done something to have an impact. But no, you haven't. You've only punished one guy, and you've done nothing whatsoever to stop the international drug trade.
No, if anything, they're fanning the flames because now people are going to try to find more clever ways to get away from this situation.
Sure. I mean, the takeaway on this one is encrypt your emails when you're doing business that could be considered illegal.
Well, and I'm still curious because they keep mentioning, you know, these Bitcoins were used to buy illegal things. But was he charged with, you know, like assisting someone in purchasing an illegal substance? It doesn't sound like
a conspiracy
at all. It sounds like he was only charged with illegal money transmission.
I don't remember.
If you handed me a $5 U.S. bill that said Federal Reserve at the top, and then I handed you either the $5 Bahamian bill or the $5 Canadian in my wallet, then we would be involved in an illegal money transaction.
How dare you?
Would we be? I don't know what the laws are, so
I don't have a license. You don't have a license.
That's true.
You're not authorized to make that transaction, you guys. You have to fill out the proper paperwork before you can really tell if it's fair. You might be devaluing the dollar. Dear Lord.
Might be laundering this money.
Yeah, it's pretty ridiculous. You are welcome to share your thoughts here at 855-450-FREE, but I agree, Ellen, with your assessment that it's sad when people are convicted of crimes that have no victim. There's no one who was harmed in this case.
No, they were doing people a valuable service.
Right. Both of the people who are transacting in this case were transacting voluntarily. No one was feeling like they got ripped off. The guy, you know, Charlie was charging a percentage to make the transaction, and this guy was going on Silk Road and charging people a percentage to make transactions with him. And so everybody would have been fine had they just been left alone. But these federal agents are on this crusade to try to stop the flow of drugs. And it's just such a futile thing. But ultimately, this seems more like it's about money because they're getting nearly $1 million out of these men.
Out of each of them.
Right. I mean, that's not going to any kind of victim. It's not going to go to make anyone whole.
The state is always the victim, Ian.
Well, it's ridiculous. The state doesn't exist.
Why don't you know this by now?
The state's just an idea. It can't be a victim of anything.
Well, apparently it was a victim of $950,000 apiece.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. So I think it's sad that Trem was saying earlier that you quoted him saying,
right, he said that he knew what he was doing was wrong. Which, when I first read that, I thought, well, maybe they're skewing his words because he could have said something like, I knew that what I was doing was legally wrong. Like, technically speaking, I would have been charged for it in court, but maybe he didn't. Maybe he said it in a way that seemed like, you know, well, it's wrong according to you, but I don't really think it's wrong. But
maybe
wording it slightly differently.
I mean, I don't know what's in Charlie Shrem's heart, but I know that he was likely saying those things in front of a judge. I suspect that was not actually a quote from a media interview,
right,
but a quote from like a statement that he was making about, oh, I've been a bad boy, judge.
He did say that in court.
Please go ahead and just deal out whatever you want. Right. I've been so bad.
Which is kind of sad.
I throw myself on your mercy.
Like, where is his integrity there? Like, he knew from the beginning what he was doing,
well,
but he still went through with it. And all of a sudden, now when he's in court, he's going to back off and say, no, this is actually wrong.
Well, there's nothing wrong with saving your own skin if you're not throwing someone else under the bus, right?
He's throwing all the other people who commit these purchases on the black market under the bus.
That's a stretch. That's a stretch.
I mean, if he's saying like...
He's not throwing anyone under the bus in that they're getting crushed by the wheels and are going to go to prison.
He's a perpetrator of this crime. And all of a sudden now he's turned against everyone else who's doing it and saying, no, you're doing something bad.
You're doing
bad.
Something wrong.
Yeah.
No, he's certainly indicting them verbally, but his action here in court of essentially eating some crow in front of the judge is going to serve him, and it will not serve him at anyone else's cost. So unlike somebody who will snitch on another person, so commonly like in the drug world, if you bust somebody, the police bust somebody, they'll demand they give up their dealer in order to get out of whatever the criminal charges are. That's throwing somebody under the bus. That's ruining somebody else's life to make your life a little bit less worse off because you won't get charged with something.
Right.
In this case, he's not doing anything like that. He's just saying, I was a bad boy and now please go easy on me, sir.
I can understand out of self-preservation if you want to, you know, try and get your charges as low as possible. But still, to me, this is just excessively cowardly if he actually... Just because...
You're used to hanging around activists.
Because
I mean,
this is like... I'm looking at it from a purely, very principled point of view.
Yeah, well, people don't have those principles.
Right,
I mean,
when it comes to practice, you can't really stick to them.
Well, that's just it. You may have the principles, but in a lot of cases, when the state comes around waving a big stick at you or a gun or whatever it is they're waving, in this case, rattling cage doors, I mean, he's facing 5 years in prison on this, and that's on the plea deal from what I understand. So he hasn't yet been sentenced, somewhat in the same way that Adam Kokesh apparently was sentenced just recently, yesterday or something like that, very, very recently. He's a totally different story. I'm hoping to get Adam on to talk more in detail about this, but in his case, it was gun charges in D.C., and he came up with some kind of a deal, but ultimately still had to face sentencing. I don't know how that works. It must be a federal thing where you make a deal, but then you're still rolling the dice to see what the judge is going to give you when sentencing happens. That sounds like what's going on with Shrem. But we'll come back with more, and you can share your thoughts at 855-450-FREE. Did Charlie Shrem do something wrong by selling Bitcoin for cash outside of the system? It's Free Talk Live.
Stop harming your body with coffee from grocery stores or most chains. Start making a difference, one cup at a time. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer you a free pound of BuzzBox coffee. It's organic, so no harmful pesticides or toxins. Shade grown, meaning less acidity and no heartburn. Try the best of the best for free. Just cover shipping. 10% of future purchases go toward helping us give the gift of human freedom around the globe with at least 100 microloans via World Vision. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com.
Breathe it in, kid. Clean, fresh air thanks to these new air handler filters. They're more energy efficient, hold more dust, and are stronger than ever. And Grainger's got over 3,000 different styles and sizes to choose from. Just ordered a new batch from Grainger.com today. I love oxygen, kid. And this facility's got some great AO2. I'm breathing easier just thinking about these air handler filters. Get some today. Get it? Got it? Good. Call, click Grainger.com/air handler or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
I didn't believe it. Neither did I. No way could you professionally remove unwanted hair pain-free and at home.
My thoughts exactly.
Remove my face and body hair without expensive, painful office visits?
Not possible. Great minds think alike.
Until I tried No-No Pro.
Mm-hmm. Wait, you tried No-No?
Yes, and it works. I use it on my face, legs, bikini line.
We're BFFs and you didn't tell me about No-No?
Here, this is my new No-No Pro. The most powerful No-No made. Custom treatment levels, less hair in less time, perfect for any skin type. Try it.
No hair, no pain, no time consuming expensive office visits?
No, no, and no, no.
For a limited time, you can try No-No Pro risk-free. You'll also get the facial kit and a travel case. Get weeks of long-lasting results.
That's it. I'm getting a No-No.
Great minds do think alike.
Try No-No Pro risk-free by calling 800-952-5760. 800-952-5760. That's 800-952-5760. 800-952-5760.
On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. Find out about giving to our Google AdWords campaign at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting bloc and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You're listening to the best liberty-oriented audio streamed around the clock, on the air, and online. This is the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
Free Talk Live, take control, toll-free here, 855-450-FREE. Skype username's LRN.FM, and that toll-free number again is 855-450-3733. Whether you want to talk about the Bitcoin world, money-transmitting, outrageous prosecutions, this guy's facing 5 years in prison because he transmitted money illegally without getting some sort of required information by the government first. And so we can come back into that discussion here in moments. But from what I understand, Charlie Shrem, the man we're talking about here tonight, who is, again, facing those 5 years, he's going to be at Coins in the Kingdom coming up at the Walt Disney World Resort in Orlando, Florida. Free Talk Live, myself, Mark, we're going to be there. We'll be broadcasting from the event. Charlie is one of the speakers who will be at the event, including some other great speakers like Jason King from Sean's Outpost, the MIT Bitcoin Project's Dan Elitzer, Kyle Drake from Skyhook, the open source Bitcoin vending machine company. Very cool little device. Happen to have one of those in the other room here. MK Lords from Bitcoin Not Bombs and many more. It's happening at the Wyndham Lake Buena Vista in downtown Disney, Saturday, October 4th.
through Monday, October 6th. And apparently Monday is going to be the day when people are going to go out to Disney World and actually, you know, have a blast. Prior to that, there's going to be all kinds of Bitcoin discussions and fun going on there. In fact, fun is mandatory at the event. Hotel rooms are $99. Kids under 12 are free. And the tickets to the event, again, just $60. For a weekend convention, $60 is an incredible deal, especially if it's happening at Disney World. It's amazing. So come celebrate Magic Internet Money at the Magic Kingdom. We'll be there. I look forward to seeing you there. Coinsinthekingdom.com. Again, coinsinthekingdom.com. That's coming up. That's going to be in about a month from now. So go get your tickets now while you still can. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. You can bring up anything. Tom's in Nashua, New Hampshire. You're on Free Talk Live. Tom.
Yeah, it's about the Foreign Accounts Tax Compliance Act. Or
that sounds exciting. That sounds like a real page-turner.
A federal law that says that banks all over the world have to tell the IRS how much money U.S. citizens have.
Or that's anybody, right.
Because anybody who was born in the United States, or if they have like one parent who was born in the United States, even if they were born in another country, they are considered by the U.S. government to be a U.S. citizen. And by the way, I'm trying to bring up to a member of the Canadian Parliament who's very much against complying with this law a loophole that I found in my passport. It says that if you accept a job with a foreign government, then under certain circumstances, you can lose your U.S. citizenship. This paragraph, this note in my U.S. passport warning people that, you know, if you do that, you can wind up losing your U.S. citizenship. And I'm trying to tell that member of the Canadian Parliament, by the way, if you offer somebody in your riding, because that's what they call MP districts in Canada, they're called ridings. If you offer them a job, let's say you've got a bloke in your constituency office who's going to be out on holiday next week, eh? Well, then they go have somebody fill in just for one day to answer the phones, eh? And, you know, they don't have to go to Ottawa to do it. They've got an office in their riding, so it's just a few kilometers down the road, eh? So anyway, they
he's trying to talk like a Canadian. Daryl's looking funny at me here. He's adding in the word "a."
Yeah, I know. Right. I'm just trying to figure out why he's trying to talk like a Canadian.
I think it's supposed
but
to be
anyway,
funny.
But anyway, if you put them to work answering the phones for one day,
so what you're saying is then they will revoke the feds will revoke their citizenship. And so, therefore, if the citizenship is revoked, yeah, then the FACTA, this thing you're talking about where the banks of the world do not have to report that person to the IRS?
That's right, because they've thereby renounced their citizenship without having to go through all the trouble and
the renunciation. That's an interesting point, because
we were talking about that last week.
Yeah, that's right. We were talking about that, where the feds have increased by 440%, I think it was, the fee that you have to pay in order to just apply to remove your citizenship. Go ahead, Tom.
Okay, and what I'm bringing up here is they don't admit they ever were a U.S. citizen. They simply take a job working for one day at the by the way, let me interject one thing, not to change the subject, but she was mentioning on the program about trustees going in and out of the prison. And let me mention to people who are confused about that, that means prisoners who are trusted. That does not mean people who are on the board of trustees. Okay?
You were talking about when we were discussing smuggling earlier. Thanks, Tom, for the call. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So
right.
I get what
Sorry
he's saying.
Sorry if that wasn't clear enough. When I said trustees, I meant prisoners who are, you know, capable of going out and doing these jobs. I didn't mean anybody who was in a trusted position working in the hierarchy of the prison.
So I get what Tom's saying there. He's saying it was sort of a long reach about back to the last discussion we had about the renouncing one's citizenship. So in order to renounce citizenship, you have to acknowledge you were a citizen in the first place, which, of course, as I pointed out last week, nobody's actually a citizen because the government, at least in this country, in the U.S., has no obligation to protect you. And a citizen is someone.
Unless you go to a different country and you're like, well, I'm just going to get a job working for some other country's government so I can avoid all that stuff.
So you would be, in theory, able to avoid having to go through the process of renouncing your citizenship, which, of course, if you are like me and you don't believe citizenship exists, that would be a way to do it. Of course, then you'd have to hold your nose and actually work for the government in order to do
but
that.
But you wouldn't have to admit anything about citizenship, really. It would just happen automatically.
Well, that's what he was saying.
He said in some cases it can be.
It can be automatic? What can
be? The renunciate, like the automatic revocation, can be. So it's not a guarantee.
I see.
And I could see one of these things of if a large number of Americans started getting jobs for foreign governments for even a day and then saying, I'm no longer an American citizen. Well, and then the feds would be like, no, it's not automatic. You still got to do X, Y, and Z.
Odds are good. Large numbers of Americans are never going to do that. Odds are good. Fairly small numbers will probably not go through those hassles.
So. Right. But, you know, if the people that are trying to expatriate anyway, and we know that that number is going up.
Oh, yeah.
Then if those people then find out, oh, I can go this other route and not have to go the original way. That's what I meant by an increase. Was
a noticeable increase.
The number of people, what is it, like 1,300 people in the last several years that have renounced their citizenship.
Ooh, so is that all?
It's not a huge number.
Huh.
But it's still...
It's higher than average?
It's definitely on the
average. Right, the number keeps going up every year.
So on average, what, like 5 years ago, it was only a few hundred every single year?
I think so.
That's kind of shocking
to me.
Huh? Yeah. I mean, for... All the people that are immigrating here, I'd imagine, at least half that number are, emigrating.
They don't make it easy to leave. Again, this isn't just people who are emigrating, right? This is people who are renouncing citizenship.
Right, expatriating completely.
So going all the way. Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. So we've been talking about sort of the money world here with Bitcoin, this amazing decentralized currency that's taking the world by storm. And, of course, there's all kinds of stuff happening in the Bitcoin universe. It's very exciting to focus on that. And liberty-minded people are, in a lot of ways, very interested in this because Bitcoin can provide folks with some level of financial independence. For instance, if you are going to go over to another country and live, it's nice to have Bitcoin, especially as Bitcoin becomes more accepted, because then you don't have to transfer money from one form to another, and you can avoid, hopefully, if Bitcoin continues on, you could hopefully avoid even having to open a bank account in another country, because that's what the feds are using to target people from the United States. They're using the banks of the world to send them information. And I don't understand how this works. I don't get how the federal government can write some kind of law and have the world's banks respond to it.
Well, do you remember there was the thing a couple of years ago where the U.S. government was threatening the Swiss banks? Because the Swiss banks, they don't necessarily tie a name to the account. They tie a number to the account.
Right, and it's more anonymous. But isn't the U.S. Federal Reserve note, isn't that the global currency?
It's fairly well accepted around the globe, but
so they have a lot of sway when it comes to, dealing with other banks.
But what do they do? I mean, how do they push themselves onto these banks? I mean, what... They
I just
can't
imagine
regulate
it's
them.
Some sort of political pressure. Like, maybe there's some sort of, awkward
are they pressuring
conversation.
They're pressuring the governments.
And then they're pressuring
the world
governments.
And then the governments are pressuring the banks.
I see.
In a lot of places, those banks are controlled by a government.
Yes. Okay, good point. Toll-free number here, 855-450-FREE. Salon.com says there are 7 very strange libertarian ideas. We'll share some of those with you coming up here in moments on Free Talk Live, and you can share your thoughts.
Americans are reeling from Obamacare, higher prices, and an epidemic of policy lapses. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com has you covered. World-class medical and surgery at one of Asia's most modern hospitals. 300 doctors, surgeons, and dentists serving 300,000 patients a year. Fractions of U.S. prices. Friends or family forced to go out of pocket? Avoid bankruptcy. Tell them to run. Run like hell. Hit us up now. We'll show you how. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.
I'm Chuck Woolery. I don't know about you, but I don't like taking pills for minor arthritis pain, and I really don't like those patches either. But I have found something that works, Australian Dream. It's an arthritis pain relief cream. It's a great product. It doesn't smell or burn. It isn't greasy, and it works. And Australian Dream has an empty jar guarantee, so you can use a whole jar, and if you're not happy, you get your money back. But I doubt that you'll send it back. You know, the stuff really works. Get Australian Dream at Walgreens, CVS, or Walmart. You'll be glad you did.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kit Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kitessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number 2 is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Darryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Friday, September 5th, 2014. Silver is trading at $19.11 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,265 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $487. Antiwar.com reports Afghanistan's 2 presidential candidates sought to reassure NATO yesterday, issuing a statement promising they will form a government of national unity and reiterating that whichever one wins, they are committed to signing a new troop deal with NATO occupation forces in the nation beyond 2015. The comments were intended to calm NATO during its ongoing summit, which was supposed to hype their victory in Afghanistan with the invitation of the Afghan president, but there isn't one, as the count has gone on for months. Ashraf Ghani is expected to win after his opponent, Abdullah Abdullah, withdrew from the audit process. Abdullah produced evidence of substantial ballot stuffing on Ghani's behalf. The power-sharing deal was supposed to be all set months ago, but Ghani suggested he won't be bound by the terms of that deal. Yesterday's promise of a unity government seems highly speculative, and nothing beyond the continued occupation seems to be resolved. FPP Radio News is brought to you by Roberts & Roberts Brokerage. For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They now take Bitcoin for purchasing precious metals so you can turn your profits into a long-term investment. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing. 800-874-9760. Reuters reports, lawyers for the state of Utah believe they have the perfect case for the U.S. Supreme Court to decide once and for all the hotly contested legal rights issue of whether states can ban same-sex marriage. But so do lawyers in Virginia and Oklahoma, setting the scene for the high court to take the crucial first step as soon as September 30th on which same-sex case or cases the 9 justices will hear in their next term, which begins on October 6th. The court's choice of a case or cases could affect when, if ever, gay men and lesbians in the 31 states that now bar them from marrying could get marriage licenses. The case selection will also do much to decide the scope of any ruling, including if the court is to decide definitely whether gay men and lesbians have a constitutional right to marry. While lawyers have made preliminary claims for and against same-sex marriage in their filings, and also presented arguments about why their particular case might be the best for the justice to hear, both sides agree the Supreme Court needs to end the legal uncertainty without further delay. For instance, states that now ban same-sex marriage also refuse to recognize marriages that take place in one of the 19 states where same-sex marriage is legal. This can complicate matters for gay couples adopting children or for a gay person seeking permission to make medical decisions on behalf of a spouse. State officials defending the bans counter that the U.S. Constitution does not dictate how a state should define marriage, and that there is no deeply rooted legal tradition that supports a right to same-sex marriage. You can support FPP Radio by shopping online. Whether you're looking for t-shirts, precious metals, bitcoins, or books, you'll find that and more at shop.fppradio.com. Every purchase you make from one of my affiliates at shop.fppradio.com helps fund FPP Radio. That's shop.fppradio.com. USA Today reports the fast food industry suffered some image indigestion Thursday when more than 430 workers demonstrating for higher wages in dozens of cities were arrested, according to organizers. Those arrests included Representative Gwen Moore from Wisconsin in West Milwaukee. She joined fast food workers from New York City to Chicago to Los Angeles to put down their burger flippers and pick up picket signs in a strike for $15 per hour as a minimum wage. The rallies included acts of civil disobedience, mostly blocking streets. Kendall Fells, organizing director of Fast Food Forward, says there has to be civil disobedience because workers don't see any other way to get $15 an hour and a union. In a statement, McDonald's said, "We believe that any minimum wage increase should be implemented over time so that the impact is manageable." The demands of the protest are for major fast food companies to pay a $15 per hour minimum wage and for workers to be able to unionize without retaliation. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
In what medical authorities are calling one of the worst ointment complications in White Plains Hospital's history, area girlfriend Caroline Nagler was rushed to the ER this week after suffering an extreme overdose of scented lotion. With a blood lotion level of 0.45, hospital sources confirmed that Nagler had rubbed onto her body four times the lethal limit of shea butter, green tea cleanses, and naturally soothing mineral therapies.
Even putting aside the sheer level of lotion Miss Nagler had on her person when she arrived at the ER, this was an especially lethal combination she was using. She was mixing scented moisturizers, age-defying serums, and even some harder stuff like jojoba and essential fruit extracts. Frankly, she's lucky to be alive.
In other news, Beijing's air solidifies. A Delta Airlines counteragent assures a man he will never see his family again. And a mannequin must think he's some pretty hot s***. They say if you love something, let it go. But how could we possibly leave you behind after being blessed with a relationship as unique and complex as this one? For more, keep checking TheOnion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
This is Free Talk Live, and you can take control here toll-free. We spent most of the first hour talking about money transmitting, bitcoins, Silk Road, various different aspects of that. And the Liberty Movement is becoming more and more persuasive to people out there. There are big names like Ron Paul and, of course, smaller names like Free Talk Live, where, you know, we're getting out there, getting the ideas of freedom into people's heads. And as a result of all this liberty motion, there are some people that are feeling kind of threatened by that. Now, we've pointed out before here on Free Talk Live, and by the way, the we includes me, Ian, tonight.
Alan.
And Daryl.
Multiple times we have pointed out how when you do activism, when you get the ideas of freedom out there in a way that is effective, in a way that brings people in a way that gets people interested, or at the very least gets them talking, you're going to see pushback. You're going to see people upset about that. You're going to see those people who are upset about that, you're going to see them do some nasty stuff. Some of them will lie. They'll make up things about you, or they'll make up things about the liberty movement. They'll make up, you know, false ideas and start spreading those. They'll make up lies and misinformation about the people who are within the movement and start spreading those. We've seen that happen here in Keene. And I think that there are some people who believe that, oh, you guys in Keene, you're just doing it wrong. If you did it my way, if you did your action, your politics, or whatever it is that is the critique of the moment, the critique du jour, if you did it my way, then you guys wouldn't come up against the opposition. You'd have been freer in Keene now if you'd just done it my way. There's
a lot
of people.
Don't you think there's
critics.
Opposition in every group?
That's my point, is that there are a lot of people who are critics of the way some of the activists do things, like up here in New Hampshire, specifically here in Keene. But I think most of those people have never been part of a movement that has been as effective as the activists in New Hampshire, and specifically in Keene. And so they don't know what it's like once their ideas start to actually penetrate into the populace, once their activism becomes visible. Because in a city like New York, for instance, or, you know, Sacramento, large cities, you're not going to be as noticeable as you are if you're in a place like Keene, New Hampshire, with population 25,000. FreeKeene.com, the website that I created here, and Daryl, you're one of the bloggers for it.
Yes.
FreeKeene is one of the more popular blogs in New Hampshire, let alone Keene. It's the only blog that I know of in Keene. Maybe there's something else out there, but I've looked, and there's not really much else in the way of blogs here. There's the newspaper website. There's the radio station website, but FreeKeene's one of the only news sources in Keene.
So
there's Stop FreeKeene.
SFK isn't a news source?
I guess you're right. Stop FreeKeene's a blog. Thanks for they're just
or
so forgettable.
Properly, Stop FreeKeene!
With three exclamations. And you were actually muting yourself, and thank you for that.
And backed
loud.
Away from yes. the microphone.
Yeah, I appreciate the mic technique there. But my point generally here is that when you start having an impact, people are going to get upset about it. And the Liberty Movement, while on a national scale, it hasn't had an impact in any meaningful way, like, you know, Liberty people haven't been elected. Okay, you're going to, somebody's going to argue, Rand Paul. Well, he's not really a libertarian person. He won't even use the word libertarian to describe himself. So taking him off the table.
If he does use the word libertarian, it's always immediately followed by Republican. It's always libertarian Republican. It's never
ridiculous.
Libertarian standalone.
So taking him off the table, there's nobody else really worth, you know, talking about that's doing anything nationwide. And if there is, please bring that to the table and let us know. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. I did hear recently, just as an aside before we get to the story about from Salon.com, there was a guy who contacted me, actually Brett Hatley, formerly of the Bubba the Love Sponge show down in Florida. He contacted me to let me know that there's something exciting happening in Florida. Apparently, the person running for Senate or House, one or the other, U.S. Senator House in Florida, one of those people in Florida is a libertarian candidate who apparently is in a two-person race in the general election.
Yeah, it's one of the House races.
Yeah, so he's up against, I think, a Democrat or a Republican, one or the other. He's up against one of the other two parties, and people are all excited thinking that this guy's going to have a chance and that he's going to get in. Like, he's in a Republican district, and the Republican's not running, and he's up against a Democrat, and so they think he's going to run. Or, I'm sorry, it might be the reverse. But either way, he's in a two-person race. And I was in a situation like that in Florida as well, and it didn't work out. The Libertarian only got, like, 30% in a two-person race. So I wish him the best. I really hope it's going to work out. But there's just not much you can point to as far as libertarians being successful politically. However,
well, there was one county in Florida where enough libertarians got elected to the Soil and Water Board that they were able to abolish the board that they had all gotten elected to.
That's news. I hadn't heard about that.
Yeah, that happened probably 8-9 months ago.
Wow. Okay. I would have loved to have known more about that. That's fascinating. I'm sure the Florida government is shaking in their shoes as a result of that. And that's just it. In most places, the libertarians are just a sideshow. They're, you know, they're out there just trying their darndest to get on the ballot. And then once
well,
they expend
at least
all
they
their
get
resources,
on the ballot in Florida.
Yeah, well, once they expend all their resources on that, it's kind of hard to run a campaign up against big money Republicans and Democrats. So it's hard for the libertarians to get to make an impact politically. But at the very least, you could make the argument that libertarians, mostly due to Ron Paul, have kind of made an impact on the national scene. I mean, Ron Paul was someone who could not be ignored in the 2008 and 2012 presidential campaigns.
Right, and now more people are starting to question, well, if that's what they deem as libertarian, then maybe there's a little bit of that in me. And
it's true.
You know, like, a lot of people seem to have something that they feel particularly, you know, driven to the same viewpoint as libertarians on. It's just one specific thing and it's not as general. But I feel like because of Ron Paul, now a lot of people are more comfortable to say that. It's kind of like going to the family reunion and saying, like, oh, I'm an atheist. Like, all your relatives are going to be really concerned at that point and start giving you pieces of advice. If, like, if you say, oh, I'm a libertarian at the dinner table, you know, then you get those awkward glances.
But it'll go better now than because of Ron Paul. Like,
exactly.
You're more likely, if you're sitting at the Thanksgiving table with the whole family, you're more likely to have, if it's a fairly large table with, let's say, 25 people at it, you're more likely somebody else sitting there will know who Ron Paul is and have a good feeling about Ron Paul. So I think that's something that's changed over the last decade. Having been involved with libertarian politics for many years, I started in the year 2000. So I've been at this for a decade and a half at this point. And I remember doing outreach back in the year 2000, going to the county fair, the gun shows, gay and lesbian pride fest, and doing outreach to people. People didn't know what a libertarian was. They had, most of them, the super majority of them, never heard of the word libertarian, just the word, never heard of it. And then of those who had known what libertarian, of those who had heard of libertarian, the word, almost none of them knew what it meant. None of them, because I'd always ask, oh, you know, you've heard this? Well, how would you describe it? And the usual answer was, nobody had any clue. And I think that's changed. I think more people are aware generally of what libertarianism is, and I think Ron Paul's a big factor there. And so you're seeing that pushback I was talking about. When you start having an impact, you start getting pushback. And Salon.com is pushing back. And outside of New Hampshire, the pushback's all intellectual. In New Hampshire, people get arrested and things like that for doing activism, and we're being targeted, and there's a lot more like real life pushback. You know, we've had the house has been egged, things like that. But online, it's all discussions and intellectual stuff. So here's a story from Salon.com, who has been making a real point, originally appearing on alternet.org. But anyway, Salon has been highlighting anti-libertarian articles for the last couple years. They must be feeling like libertarians are making an impact. They must be feeling like the ideas are on the rise because they feel like they have to target them. Because if you're not impactful, if your ideas aren't a challenge to the status quo, then nobody really has any reason to refute you. They don't have any reason to spend time on you. But if Salon is spending time debunking libertarian or attempting to debunk libertarian arguments or make us look crazy or stupid, then that means that the libertarians are doing something, that there's some level of threat out there. And I think that's important. This is the 7 strangest libertarian ideas, according to Richard Esko from Alternet. Number 1 on the list: parents should be allowed to let their children starve to death. And we'll get into the details on it here in moments. And we'll see how many of the crew in the studio here tonight agrees that parents should be allowed to let their children starve to death. We'll dig into that here. 855-450-FREE. And how do you feel? You're welcome to share that with us here on Free Talk Live. 855-450-3733 is the Pro XPN toll-free line. This is Free Talk Live. Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
Wake up and smell the freedom. One of the easiest things you can do to help Liberty is to torrent Freedom Fiends episodes to help keep them drone-proof. You can set up your home computer to download and share Freedom Fiends archives over BitTorrent. You can even set up scheduling so it only shares while you're asleep or at work. Put your unused computing power to work and help keep the Freedom Fiends around well into the future. Simply go to freedomfiends.com and click on the Torrent Club link and learn how to torrent and share Freedom Fiends archives.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year, Rich Paul is our first announced keynote speaker, and more are being announced now at keenvention.info. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 31st through November 2nd. You can pre-order your tickets now for just $60 at keenvention.info, or you can pay with Bitcoin. Visit keenvention.info for more information and to lock in your tickets at the pre-order $60 price for the whole weekend. Visit keenvention.info for more, or look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateur, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolf. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. What's the craziest thing you've heard a libertarian say? I mean, there's no doubt some libertarians have said some crazy stuff over time. So I can't blame certain salon/alternate writers for either hearing things that actually were said that were crazy by someone who's a libertarian, or misinterpreting things that were said that weren't so crazy but sounded like they might be crazy because they weren't said very effectively. That's all a possibility. We're going to get into the seven strangest libertarian ideas, at least according to alternate.org's Richard Esko, here in moments. And I want to remind you about how to get a pound of free coffee, some of the best coffee out there, BuzzBox. You can go to coffee.freetalklive.com. It's 100% organic and top 1% grade Arabica, as well as shade grown. This is good coffee. In fact, the thing they really do that's special over at BuzzBox, because, you know, you can get a good coffee in a lot of different places, but you can't get a pound for free as long as you pay the shipping cost. You can do that at coffee.freetalklive.com. But something else they do is they give a portion of the purchase price to charity, essentially. And we actually had been working with World Vision, but there were some changes involved, and we've reselected a new charity. Some people didn't like that World Vision was kind of like this religious based organization. Obviously, we have a lot of skeptics and atheists in our audience here at Free Talk Live, especially on the online audience. And so we've actually, we're going to team up with Kiva, which is the first organization I'd ever heard of that was doing microloans.
Yes.
And so we're actually going to be taking some of the cut, I think it's like 5%, that BuzzBox will send back to us. We're going to be giving that to Kiva to fund microloans around the world. So BuzzBox works with groups like Free Talk Live and others to help promote charities and help people out all around the world, which is very exciting. So you can actually get that free pound of coffee and get on the auto ship program at coffee.freetalklive.com. You just pay the shipping cost for that first pound, and it is free beyond that. The subscription, you can cancel that at any time. But once you get started at coffee.freetalklive.com, you get to kind of sculpt your own auto delivery system where you can decide how much coffee you want delivered at any moment. Maybe you need a pound, maybe you need more than a pound. Or you can decide. You can also decide how often it's delivered. So you need a pound every 4 weeks, need a pound every 2 weeks. I don't know how fast you go through it, and they don't know either. That's why you tell them. Coffee.freetalklive.com. Go there and get your free pound today. Just, again, pay that shipping cost. The pound itself will cost you nothing. Coffee.freetalklive.com. The story from Salon.com. I want to read you their intro here first before we get into number one on these alleged seven strangest libertarian ideas. Number one being... parents should be allowed to let their children starve to death. But first, the intro from alternate.org. Few movements in the United States today harbor stranger political ideas than the self-proclaimed libertarians. The Rand Paul School of Libertarianism is at least as far outside the mainstream on the right as, say, a rather doctrinaire old-school form of Marxism-Leninism is on the left. And again, they're wrong right out the gate by using the term libertarian interchangeably with Rand Paul, or to suggest that there's a Rand Paul school of libertarianism, as though he's got his own brand of libertarianism.
Right, well, and I was just saying he turned against that name, didn't he?
He will not accept the term libertarian for himself.
Right, he won't accept the term for himself. Other people try to give the term to him and then say that everything he does somehow fits within libertarianism. So I would say that... there might be a school of Rand Paul libertarianism, but Rand Paul ain't the headmaster of it.
Yeah, exactly. And this just shows how twisted the ideas of liberty can be. You get somebody out there like Rand Paul, a few people in the media call him a libertarian. All of a sudden, everybody in the media is calling him a libertarian.
And then they also make the false assumption that libertarianism is somehow to the right when libertarian... And I had a program director a couple days ago that I was explaining the ideas about this show to.
Because you call radio stations to pitch Free Talk Live, and thank you for that.
And mentioned libertarian, and he didn't really understand. And I said, well, you know, we disagree with liberals as much as we agree with conservatives, and we disagree with conservatives as much as we agree with liberals. And he still kind of didn't understand it.
That doesn't really explain anything.
It doesn't, but you know, he was up.
It's showing equality, though.
Right, but he was just concerned that
you'd be one side or the other.
The owner of the station might hear us praising Obama, and I was like, no,
definitely not.
We don't agree with Obama on very much at all. We also don't really agree with the Republicans on a lot either, because libertarian, you know, it's what they call fiscally conservative, socially liberal.
Yeah, that's a decent way of a very short and fairly accurate way of describing libertarians. So back to the story here. The difference, he says, this is alternate.org. The difference is this. The mainstream media isn't telling us that we're in the middle of a Marxist-Leninist moment. Leninist politicians aren't being touted as serious presidential contenders. And all the media chatter we're hearing about a libertarian moment ignores the very harsh, extreme, and sometimes downright ugly ideas that are being disseminated under that banner. It's great to have allies like Rand Paul working alongside other Americans to defend our right to privacy, restrain the NSA, and reduce the military-industrial complex grip on foreign policy. It's possible to admire their political courage in these areas while at the same time recognizing that we may not care for the environment they inhabit. There's another reason to challenge libertarians on the extreme nature of their ideology. A number of them seem determined to drive competing ideas out of the free market of ideas, which isn't very libertarian of them. There has been a concerted effort to marginalize mainstream values, whatever that means, and ideas about everything from workers' rights to the role of government in national life. So by all means, let's have an open debate. Let's make sure that all ideas, no matter how unusual they may seem, are welcome for debate and consideration, but let's not allow any political movement to become a Trojan horse, one which is allowed to have a moment without ever telling us what it really represents. Obviously, not every self-proclaimed libertarian believes these ideas, but libertarianism is a space which nurtures them. Can the Republican Party really succeed by embracing this space? Why does the mainstream media treat libertarian ideas as somehow more legitimate than, say, the social welfare principles which guide Great Britain or Sweden? here are seven of modern libertarianism's strangest and most extreme notions.
How?
So before we jump into this,
yes.
I know you have a question. Did you want to go first?
No, go ahead.
Okay. So I'm just thinking, they're asking, like, how are they viewing these libertarian points as more legitimate than, you know, policies that people practice overseas? But if you look, like, Europe is not doing that great. And neither is Russia or Africa or any other country over there, really, besides China and maybe Japan. But the thing is, like, free market principles work better. And that's what libertarianism advocates. So
it's also bunk to claim that people aren't on television advocating for nationalized health care. I mean, that's ridiculous. There's
right.
all kinds of people purporting that.
I'm curious how the author of this article is somehow under the delusion that mainstream media is somehow touting libertarian ideals.
Well, there have been some articles. I think there was a New York Times piece, right, which actually featured the Free State Project and the Porcupine Freedom Festival. There was some sort of New York Times article about the libertarian moment.
Well, they're labeling everything libertarianism.
Right, but they weren't touting our ideas. They were saying, here's some people that believe this.
They're trying to mislabel it.
Well, they don't like that. They don't like any of that. I mean, these people don't. The guy writing this article would prefer to not have any of those things happen. And there has been extra attention given in the mainstream media to libertarianism within the last half a decade. More coming up.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right, that's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
A report finds it's not okay to just start talking to people you don't know, and a monstrosity is created in the Frito-Lay laboratory. This is the Onion Week in Review. Local newborn Nathan Jameson surprised the world earlier this morning by irrevocably losing all faith in humanity after just 6 days. Though he's not yet developed the capacity for speech, spokespeople for the six-day-old baby have confirmed he already knows that humans cannot be trusted and that most people lack self-awareness about their own destructive tendencies.
While most people need around 30 or 40 years to truly understand that the vast majority of humanity is shallow and irredeemable, baby Nathan's convinced that he has seen all that he needs to see. People have been nice and even brought him toys and presents. But the fact is, Nathan knows they're all full of shit.
And in this week's science report, botanists discover trees are all slowly trying to strangle each other. In other news, a fun-loving turtle is all business when it comes to feeding time, and a partygoer rolls a couple of fat burritos to pass around.
This is the Onion News Network.
If you want to move to the free state and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the Liberty Media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
Do you love Twitter? Make sure you favorite the LRN.FM Twitter account so you can receive our tweets at twitter.lrn.fm. That's twitter.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls. You may dial in toll-free here. We've got the 7 strangest libertarian ideas. It's an article from alternet.org and Salon, reprinted over at salon.com. We'll get into that. We've actually not even scratched the surface of number one, which is that parents should be allowed to let their children starve to death. So we'll dig into that here in a moment. Also, if you need focus and are feeling fatigued and trying to get that extra edge when it counts, check out modafinil from modup.net. Studies show 1 in 5 students use this cognitive enhancer, offering multiple benefits, including a double-digit increase in short-term memory, fighting off fatigue, and greater focus overall so you can get things done. Businessmen are talking about modafinil from modup.net and how it's making the difference in their work and giving them the critical edge that they need. And over at modup.net, they make it affordable for everyone to take advantage of the benefits of modafinil by being 80 to 85% lower in price than the brand name. But don't mistake low prices for inferior quality. They ensure that purity and potency are consistent to that of the branded version at modup.net. Remember, Free Talk Live is an international radio show, and modup.net ships worldwide. It's your responsibility to know if local prescription requirements and laws apply. So check that out. Go to modup.net, and if you pay with Bitcoin, you'll save 33%. Plus, use code FTL, like Free Talk Live, and you'll get 10 free tablets with your order. So check it out at modup.net, world-class service for modafinil at a great price. And don't forget code FTL, modup, M-O-D-U-P.net. Let's go to the phones first before we get into the story from Salon. Greg is in New York. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Ellen, and Daryl.
Hey, what's up?
Hey, Greg.
Hearing modup kind of makes me think of Barney Stinson. Modup, you know.
Barney who?
Sorry. It's from How I Met Your Mother.
I haven't seen it.
Never watched it.
Never mind. Okay. I used to call in the past and really talk about decentralizing organizations and stuff like that. And I just kind of wanted to talk about the other way, which is why things might be good to be centralized in some areas. And
which areas?
Right. So I think, in a nutshell, the role of government, and this is why I consider myself a minarchist, the role of government is basically to ensure that people's minimum expectations are met. So what I mean by that is, like, 2,000 years ago, people didn't expect that water would come to their, you know, to their house, or that they would have relative safety, let's say, within a certain area. Whereas, you know, fast forward to now, we expect having the internet and having water and stuff like that. We expect education for our kids. We expect minimum health care and stuff like that.
I don't know. I would say that in the Roman Empire 2,000 years ago, they did have running water. So people in, you know, certain parts of Rome would expect to have running water. In certain parts of Rome, they would expect to be protected from savages.
In certain parts, yeah. And aqueducts were public projects. So that's actually a good example of a public good. But, maybe Rome was not the best example. But certainly other societies didn't have water coming to their house. What I'm trying to say is that our expectations for everything from healthcare to education are rising every 100 years. They're constantly getting to the point where we wouldn't be happy living the way that a 14th century person would be living.
Well, I think that's kind of subjective. Some people might enjoy that. I mean, a lot of people that live in New Hampshire like the roughing it lifestyle, and I'm sure that people would adapt to it pretty quickly if it meant that they could live out their lives doing what they find enjoyable. I mean, it would take a lot of advancement away, sure. Like, there wouldn't be as great technology. Like, you probably couldn't use your cell phone anymore, but it would still be, you know, a lot less stressful than what people are used to now.
Oh, I totally agree with that. I mean, there's a lot of people that would love to live out in the not necessarily in the wilderness, but out in nature. But at the same time, you know, if you get some kind of infection, you do appreciate that you can go see, you know, you can travel and go see a doctor who will maybe save your life.
Oh, sure.
Mm-hmm. Which has nothing to do with the government, but okay.
Well, that's what I'm trying to say, is that if everyone wants something, for example, access to basic health care like that, then it makes sense for everyone to collectively bargain for that thing, because...
But that's not what happens with the government. I mean, with the government, you've got people who are politicians who are do not have your best interests in mind. They have the best interests of the corporations and their, you know, their paymasters, their controllers. They have their interests in mind. So the idea that you're using the government to somehow collectively bargain is ridiculous. And when you use the government to provide services, you're relying on a monopoly, which by definition is inefficient and in a lot of ways, you know, and can be abusive. It's protectionist.
Well, hold on.
I think
the government that we have today is not a minimal government, first of all.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't have, when you have a monopoly, when you say it's inefficient, in this case, this is something called a monopsony, which is the opposite of a monopoly. It's basically one buyer. It's a, like a single buyer for healthcare, for example. And what happens is the single buyer can negotiate a better rate than if all the grandmas are competing against each other to get that same healthcare.
Well, that sounds like
a
fantasy. I mean, what is the evidence you have that when there's no competition that you can somehow negotiate a better rate?
Oh, that's basic economics. I mean, there's tons of evidence for this. For example, Medicare is much more efficient in terms of the prices it gets than pretty much every other insurance company.
What?
Well,
have you ever actually talked to doctors who accept Medicare?
That's the point. They're squeezed by Medicare.
Squeezed to the point where they have to make up the difference by charging cash clients more. So in a lot of cases, the Medicare won't even pay for the services that you know, that the doctor is providing. And that's why more and more doctors, from what I understand, are considering and or are leaving accepting Medicare and even accepting insurance in a lot of cases.
Right. There's a lot of problems with American healthcare, but if you look at the correlation, this is about as strong as it gets. All across the world, in every developed country except America, healthcare costs are much lower, and if you look at all of them, all developed countries in the world, they all have nationalized healthcare one way or the other.
And they all have incredibly long wait times for basic operations that in the U.S. you would wait maybe like a week. In Canada, you're waiting months.
In Canada, maybe, but if you look at other countries, there's actually some of them have much better outcomes than the U.S. Mm. Some of them have more doctors per person than the U.S. How is that possible? If you're saying that it's much less efficient. In other words,
you're comparing one broken system to other broken systems, so it's inevitable that some things are going to be less broken than others about some of those portions of those systems. So I'm not a fan of the current system in the United States. I think it sucks. And if you want to become a doctor here, you've got to jump through a bunch of ridiculous hoops that have been put up by the American Medical Association that prevent competition, that prevent people from getting out there and offering services, prevent nurses who can do the same things in a lot of cases that doctors can, but they are not allowed to do those things unless there's a doctor present or something like that. So there's all kinds of rules that restrict the marketplace, restrict the supply of doctors here in the United States. We could have more doctors if there weren't as many rules that the government bureaucracy has put in front of them to prevent them from getting into business, and the AMA, which is a cartel essentially of the doctors.
Right,
and
but if you think about it this way, it's really just an easy, quick solution to a problem that everybody has, which is how do you choose who to buy from, like which hospital you're going to go to. Like, you obviously you want the best care, and it's more reassuring if a hospital that you go to is like publicly funded by you know, Medicare. Or
is that more reassuring?
To a lot of people,
me.
It is.
To some people.
Because they're like, oh, this person's licensed, and look at all of these customers that they have. They must be okay. Because they don't want to take the time researching each individual doctor. Mm-hmm. They don't have time for that.
And if you're only comparing, you know, the per capita rate of doctors in one country to doctors in the U.S., The state of California, as I understand, has more lawyers per capita than anywhere else in the country, but that doesn't mean that the legal system in California is the best in the world.
No. If outcomes were not better, then it wouldn't matter how many.
But let me give you this one, Greg. Let's say that you're right about. Let's say you can find some country that's got better numbers in a lot of different areas in healthcare, and it's doing the government healthcare thing, the single payer, the universal healthcare, whatever you want to call it. And the United States, you know, is lacking behind that particular country. Without getting into the details on those things. I am not willing to put the ends in front of my means. I'm not willing to use violent means to get to those ends, even if those ends are more efficient. We can come back with more if you want. Hang on, Greg. 855-450-FREE. That's Free Talk Live.
This is Mark Edge of Free Talk Live, and I've got something awesome to share with you. I've recently joined Liberty.me. It's an online city devoted to people who love liberty. Break free of the flame wars and bridge-dwelling denizens of Facebook. You deserve better. You deserve a friendly, ad-free social network where you can chat 24 hours a day with like-minded souls around the world. Attend live interactive classes with experts on economics, finance, politics, and money. Access a vast library of books and discuss them with your reading group. Better your life with exclusive self-help guides on investing, self-defense, homeschooling, security, healthcare, saving money, and starting a business. Become a libertarian luminary yourself and get paid in the process by publishing your works on Liberty.me. Get tipped via PayPal and Bitcoin.
The first step towards freedom is to invest in yourself. Start your free 30-day trial now at Liberty.me.
I love being a member of Liberty.me, and I think you will too. The first month is free. Sign up and say hello.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988. Herbal Healer Academy.
Uncovering the secrets and exposing the lies. That's what the readers of freedomsphoenix.com get every day. FreedomsPhoenix.com, constantly providing the information, the real news about government policies, and the real relationship we all have with the coercive government. The real condition of the economy, innovations in technology, breakthroughs in energy, health, and computer science. Learn the truth well before it's admitted to in the lamestream media. The corporate media, nothing more than distributors of government propaganda, but now there's an alternative. FreedomsPhoenix.com. Constant news updates on the issues that affect your life in the most important ways. With liberty and property under constant attack, FreedomsPhoenix.com provides the understanding behind the propaganda, and it encourages the participation of its readers. Go to FreedomsPhoenix.com. That's Freedoms with an S, Phoenix.com. FreedomsPhoenix.com. The revolution between the ears has already happened.
If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
Every day you make investment decisions. When you do business with and hold U.S. dollars, you make an investment in the soundness of the moral philosophy and the potential longevity of the United States hegemony. People who claim a monopoly on violence around the world. If this is the investment that you want to make, please keep listening to LRN.FM. If not, stop using their currency. Use bitcoins. Get educated. We use coins.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 213-493-0309.
It's Free Talk Live. We're here to take your calls about what you want. Talking about the Salon article, which I'm sorry, it's actually originally from Alternet. Anyway, the article is The 7 Strangest Libertarian Ideas. We still have to get into that, but we've got Greg in New York. We're going to bring him back on to talk about some, you know, he's always got thoughtful ideas, and I think he's one of the better callers that that we have here on Free Talk Live, talking about the idea of government health care versus the marketplace. So we'll talk more about that here in moments. And also, speaking of taking care of yourself, you can go and hook yourself up with some My Magic Mud over at MyMagicMud.com. And as I understand it, Daryl, have you started using the My Magic Mud?
I've used it a couple of times, and it definitely gives that dentist clean feel afterwards.
It's actually a tooth powder, which I've never experienced before, My Magic Mud. It's very interesting. It's a holistic remedy for your teeth that removes plaque and detoxifies the mouth of bacteria that can cause cavities, and the product gives you a dentist clean every time you use it and is gentle on the enamel. The ingredients in My Magic Mud are also used as dietary supplements, so not only is this an effective whitener, it's also safe to swallow. Now, My Magic Mud is a teeth whitening powder. It strengthens your teeth and promotes healthy gums, as well as reverses sensitivity and soothes any pain you might be dealing with. It was created by Jessica Armand. She's a liberty-loving homeschool mother of three. And you can go to MyMagicMud.com to learn more about it. And you can also watch a video to get a little bit more info from Dr. Griffin Cole. He's a biological dentist, and he explains a lot of the benefits. Excuse me, I believe that's an interview I know that you can listen to at MyMagicMud.com. Anyway, it's very affordable, $25 for a jar of this stuff. And there's, I think, something like 150 uses per jar. So it's a heck of a deal. And it actually works. Like, people are seeing they're seeing a difference in their teeth. They're seeing it, their teeth getting whiter without having to use crazy chemicals and bleach and things like that. So check it out at MyMagicMud.com. All right, let's go back to Greg. He's in New York. And Greg, you were talking about, we ended up getting off sort of on this healthcare subject, but you were also talking about the minimum role of the state. And I'd like to come back to that in a moment. So I don't want to lose track of the original thrust of what you were talking about. But when it comes to the healthcare discussion, it's easy to get lost in the weeds of all the statistics. So, for instance, you know, Daryl said that the universal healthcare it's slow. You've got to wait a lot of time in Canada, and then you said, well, that's not the case in all the countries. And then you pointed out that in some countries there's more doctors per person than in the United States, and you know, there's all these statistics thrown out. Nobody really knows what the truth is. Who's got the right statistics? I don't know. And of course, statistics can always be manipulated. So getting bogged down in all that is kind of pointless. To me, even if it's true what you're saying, even if it's true that there's some socialist country out there that's got a better system, and by the way, I think this system's terrible in the United States. It's a mostly government-operated system, a mostly government-funded system, and it's highly government-regulated. So what we don't have in the United States is a free market in healthcare, and we're nowhere even close to having a free market in healthcare. So again, we're just comparing cancers, as far as I'm concerned, comparing these different healthcare systems. So my point is, in the ideal libertarian world, or a liberty-oriented world, the healthcare would not be provided by the state. It would not be a one-size-fits-all solution determined and dictated by some board of bureaucrats somewhere. It would be open marketplace, and there'd be all kinds of different options. You'd be able to price around, get good prices. Presumably, there'd be enough doctors available. And the thing is, even if a socialist country was doing it for less, was managing to outcompete the free marketplace, I still wouldn't support it, because socialism is based on the threat of violence. You're forcing people to pay for a system that they may or may not value. And as long as there's force involved, I can't be on the side of it. I don't care if the results are better. And some will say that makes me a crazy ideologue, but I can't justify using force on my neighbors, and I don't see how you can.
No, and you know, I feel the same way, but I think there's a lot of people that end up going to the hospital and expecting care because they're in pain and they deserve the help, but they can't afford to pay for their health care.
Mm-hmm. Well, and there's a law that's been on the books for years that says that a hospital or a doctor cannot refuse treatment if someone is there whether the person can pay or not.
I don't think we need laws like that. I think that hospitals have charity wings. They're known for that in the past. Doctors have been known for donating their time. There's certain, like in the charity wings, doctors will frequently spend time there on their own volition because it's the right thing to do, and you know they want to help the community. I mean, so we don't need to twist people's arms and threaten them with jail cells in order to get people to do the right thing. But that's essentially the argument behind the state, Greg, and that's what you're supporting here, right? Is the threat of force.
First of all, I want to say thanks for the kudos about the caller thing. I really enjoy calling as well. And listen, I think there's two different conversations whenever I call in that we just have to be aware that there are two different conversations. One is about outcomes and what actually might produce a better result in reality, having been tried. And another is about principles. And like you said, even if it produces better outcomes, it may not appeal to you to live in such a society, even if the outcomes are better for most
people. I can go down and get a good outcome by putting a gun to a bank teller's head and get several thousand dollars out of their teller tray. I mean, that's a good outcome for me.
For everybody, obviously.
But
that's debatable if that's a good. Anyway, so my point is, you know, it's kind of a little bit like if you're in the software world, if any of your listeners know about software, there's the free software movement, which was the original thing that basically they invented the GNU. Linux and stuff like that. And then there's Linux, invented by Linus Torvalds, who didn't care about this, and the open source movement, which is different. It cares more about, it doesn't care about the principle necessarily of being free. It cares about the practicality of open source and the fact that you can look at the source. And so it doesn't necessarily even force you to make your derivative software free. And basically,
In neither one of those instances is anyone being forced to use those softwares or use those operating systems.
I agree. But the relevant thing here is not that nobody's being forced. In either one, nobody's being forced. But it's whether you care about principles or whether you care about outcomes. And for my part,
there's no force, it doesn't matter. But as soon as you say that you want to kill somebody or have somebody thrown in a cage for not paying taxes or not paying for the services that you think are needed, then it does come down to force.
Greg, of course you don't want to kill anybody. Everybody who supports the government will say they don't want to kill anybody. And it's certainly true that the police will try to avoid killing you first. They'll certainly try to tase you and beat you. Before they'll kill you in a lot of cases. But ultimately, behind every government program is the force of a cage or a gun or a club or something like that. And employing those violent tools, but there will be men who will do that, and you won't be the one asking them to, but ultimately the supporting of these government programs is essentially aligning yourself with the threat of violence against people, and it's just not okay.
I understand what you're saying, and just in the interest of time, you're focusing on the end where the tax man cometh and then he sendeth the police officer after you. Yes, but look at the other end where the guy got bit in the wilderness and now he needs to go to the hospital. He has no money to pay because he's been in the wilderness for all this time. Does he have a right to health care?
Ask for help. No, he does not have a right to health care, but people should help. People who care about others should help. And I think there's a lot of human beings who care about others. I'm sorry?
So the law you talked about in 1985, in the 80s, there was the COBRA law, and the omnibus bill said that because there was few high-profile cases where patients were turned away at hospitals for inability to pay, and by the time they arrived in another hospital, they died. And so the bill was basically because it wasn't the hospital that should front necessarily that doctor or that time to help this person. Those resources should be figured out down the line. By the society. But I'm talking about the minimum, the basics. I'm not talking about letting the guy do plastic surgery on himself. Just the basics.
It doesn't matter, man. It doesn't matter what the minimums and the basics are. As long as you're threatening people with violence to fund your minimums, it's inherently immoral to me. It's not okay to go around and put guns in people's faces, and even if you're going to use the money to help your grandma who's sick, it's not okay. What's okay is to ask for help. What's okay is to request, to persuade, to cajole.
Of who? There's two ends of this. One is the police officer who threatens the deadbeat, the guy who doesn't pay taxes. Sure, fine. But on the other end, there's a guy dying in a hospital because he got turned away because the hospital didn't have the resources.
So open a hospital that doesn't turn anyone away and let the hospital that turns people away have a terrible reputation and let them lose in the marketplace rather than using violence to try to force them to do business in the way that you want.
St. Jude provides health care to people that can't afford all the time.
The Shriners.
That's what they do.
The Shriners do burn care for burn victims. Greg, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you.
Yeah, and the same thing could happen at a local scale, except for all the regulations that are in place.
That's true. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. You can take control here. You can share your thoughts on the healthcare system. Or whatever's on your mind. Still to come, the seven strangest, according to Salon and Alternet, libertarian ideas. We'll dig in moments on Free Talk Live.
At the Home Depot, buy one or more pallets of GAF Royal Sovereign 3-tab shingles and save up to 20%. Let's raise the roof, but lower the cost with bulk pricing on GAF, America's number one shingle, featuring advanced protection technology. This is worth shouting from the rooftops. Let's do this. Up to 20% off one or more pallets of select GAF shingles. More saving. More doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Valid through September 17th. U.S. only. See store for details.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom. And with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's posts pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, September 5th, 2014. Gold opened today at $1,265. Silver opened at $19.10. And Bitcoin is trading around $484.38. Today's Bitcoin price brought to you by ExpressCoin, the fastest and most reliable way to buy Bitcoin. Buy Bitcoin today at ExpressCoin.com. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. Vote Michael Cargill to get the cars moving. Learn more or sign up to volunteer at CargillForTexas.com. This political advertisement paid for by the Michael Cargill for Austin City Council District 1 campaign. In the news today, on Thursday, U.S. Attorney General Eric Holder announced the federal government is launching a second investigation into the Ferguson, Missouri Police Department. The focus will be on who the officers stop and search, how suspects are treated in jail, and the department's officer training. The investigation will be handled by the Justice Department's Civil Rights Division. The news comes after weeks of protests following the police shooting of 18-year-old Michael Brown. Jacob Lavoro, the 19-year-old man arrested in Williamson County, Texas, for possessing and selling pot brownies, received his trial date this week. Lavoro was originally facing life in prison, but the first-degree felony charges associated with his case were dropped, quite possibly due to the massive outcry from local and national activists and supporters. Justin Armand, executive director of Texans for Accountable Government, is one such supporter. He was present during the court proceedings and told the Liberty Beat that Jacob needs public support as he still faces charges that could carry up to 20 years in prison. Justin called Lavoro a peaceful young man who would be considered an entrepreneur in Colorado. Lavoro's court date has been set for December 1st, with a pretrial date set for November 12th at 1:30. At the pretrial hearing, Lavoro's attorney will present a motion to suppress certain evidence on the grounds that police entered his home illegally. The Liberty Beat will keep you up to date as this story unfolds. San Antonio Police Chief William McManus received support from the City Council Public Safety Committee this week when he presented a proposal, first revealed by News Radio WOAI, to ticket motorists who give money to street corner panhandlers. McManus told the committee there are alternative ways to give, as money given on the street, quote, goes for drugs and goes for alcohol. McManus said he would make a formal presentation on his plan next month. Support for the Liberty Beat comes from My Magic Mud, all-natural teeth whitener. Go to MyMagicMud.com to hear a short interview with Dr. Griffin Cole. That's MyMagicMud.com. And the Liberty Beat is brought to you by Brave New Books, your source for all things Bitcoin. Now hosting a Bitcoin ATM in Austin, Texas. 1904 Guadalupe Street or online, BraveNewBookstore.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, September 5th, 2014. Check out the website at TheLibertyBeat.com. And like us on Facebook, Facebook.com, The Liberty Beat. Several media outlets have reported on 11 planes allegedly missing from a Libyan airport and the possibility that the planes could be used for a terror attack. The Washington Free Beacon, Al Jazeera Television, and USA Today have reported that intelligence agencies believe the jets could be used to strike targets on the 13th anniversary of the 9/11 attacks. A spokeswoman for the White House National Security Council told USA Today there's no confirmation that aircraft were stolen. Pictures are available online that purport to show Islamic militants standing with planes they allegedly took from an airport in Tripoli. The Huffington Post also reported that a Moroccan military expert claimed there was credible intelligence for the planes to be used in an attack on the 9/11 anniversary. Duke University and New York University have recently begun offering courses on cryptocurrencies. NYU professor Jeffrey Miller and professor David Yermak are teaching the law and business of Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies. Yermak stated the course will teach how cryptocurrencies affect the principles of finance. In the spring of 2015, Duke University finance professor Campbell Harvey will begin teaching innovation, disruption, and crypto ventures, focusing on the potential of blockchain technology. Cryptocurrency courses are already offered at the University of Nicosia in Cyprus and the UK's University of Cumbria. Support for Liberty Beat comes from Marjorie Wildcraft's Grow Your Own Groceries. Homegrown food on every table. That's growyourowngroceries.org. And support comes from Roberts & Roberts Brokerage Incorporated, specializing in precious metals since 1977. Now accepting Bitcoin. Online, rrbi.co. Or by phone, 800-874-9760. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, September 5th, 2014. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
The victims of a devastating tornado expressed gratitude that The Onion's three-part series on the disaster was reported with fairness, accuracy, and an unusual degree of sensitivity. Survivors said they were at least thankful for one thing, that The Onion put much more care and insight into their reporting of the tragedy than any competing newspaper, by far. In economic news, a Pulitzer Prize would very much help certain newspapers increase their circulation, resulting in greater ad sales and more revenue to pay their tireless, hardworking reporters, all of whom have families at home to care for. In other headlines, a group known as Americans for Fairness in Awarding Journalism Prizes is asking all Americans to help The Onion receive a Pulitzer Prize. An anonymous man says he will murder 50 innocent people if The Onion is not awarded a Pulitzer. And look at it, it's beautiful. Look, just give us a f***ing Pulitzer already, okay? This is humiliating. For more prize-worthy stories and videos, go to theonion.com/review.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. That's what we're doing here, taking your calls about anything you want. Just dial in toll-free. And bring up anything, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. With you tonight, Ian here.
Alan.
And Daryl.
And we invite you to our website at freetalklive.com. You can control the content there. You can submit whatever news story, YouTube video, blog post, whatever content you find online. You just submit the URL, come up with a title for it, and then it'll appear on our site based on our Reddit kind of base system. You can you need a Reddit account to do this. You also need a Free Talk Live account, And then you link the two accounts together in a very simple process. And it makes it easy to submit content right there to the front page of the website where other listeners can vote it up or down. So that way we'll know what you think is interesting. Of course, the best way to know is if you just pick up your phone and call into the program. You can also reach us via Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. So for those of you just tuning in, we had last hour kind of shared the preface for this Salon slash alternate piece called The Seven Strangest Libertarian Ideas. And of course, as usual, they invoke the name Rand Paul, which of course has nothing to do with true libertarianism. The idea of libertarianism being that you should be free to live your life how you want, so long as you don't hurt anybody else. And that, you know, there's this thing called the non-aggression principle. The idea is very simple that, you know, it's not appropriate to aggress against people, no matter what your goals are. We just had a conversation with Greg in New York where he was talking about the minimum that government should provide to people, the minimum healthcare, not plastic surgery, just the minimum in order to survive. We need to have these things, running water. We need governments to provide these things because when we buy in bulk, then we get a better price. But it doesn't really work out that way with governments when they buy things.
I you know, obviously I'm not old enough to remember when Nikita Khrushchev was in charge of the Soviet Union, but I have certainly seen the video where he was banging the shoe on the desk because the heel was placed on the wrong end of the shoe.
Oh, really?
Where, you know, like dress shoes, they've got the little, you know, quarter inch heel that's put on the back end.
So they did it wrong.
Right, because where's the incentive to do a good job? They get paid the same regardless. Mm. The shoes cost the same regardless because there's only one company making shoes in Soviet Russia.
Well, yeah, now that's why there's such long lines at the DMV.
That's another thing is like, well, and we didn't go there with Greg just because, you know, he's a great caller, but can't keep him on the entire show. But it begs the question, I think, of, well, if government must take care of things that are the minimum, then why aren't they running the grocery stores? I mean, if that's...
the FDA and, you know, they have other organizations regulate food safety.
Yeah, but they're just regulatory functions, right? Like, that doesn't get the food into people's mouths.
Right.
Why don't they, if it's so important, I mean, healthcare is important. So if it's so important to be fed and on Maslow's hierarchy of needs, that's definitely up there.
Yes.
They provide water on the very bottom.
Yeah.
It's the thing you need a lot of before you start worrying about other things.
Right. It's basic survival.
Arguably, you know, not quite as important as water, right? But pretty darn close.
Right.
Like right up there. Governments provide water. Why shouldn't the government run the grocery stores? And we know the answer to that question. It does a terrible job of running a grocery store, of distributing food. Bread lines are a perfect example of that.
Yeah, yes. just look at the Great Depression in the 20s.
Well, the argument, of course, would be that it was all done wrong. The socialist argument would be that, well, the Great Depression or the Soviet Union, this was all wrong. They had the wrong bureaucrats got elected. If they would just elect me,
okay,
then I would solve everything.
In Soviet Russia, there was more people dying of starvation than anything else.
Right, and there was a saying when Stalin was in charge. There was a saying, if Stalin only knew. Because they thought that Stalin was the benevolent dictator, and if he only knew all of the problems, then he would fix it.
I have never heard that one.
Well, yeah, he was the man of steel. He was
sure.
He was godlike.
Same thing in North Korea.
Yeah,
they worship Kim Jong Il and
Kim Il
Sung, and now not so much with Kim Jong Un. They're not as enamored with him. But over the decades, they've treated these dear leaders as though they are godlike almost.
Yeah.
And for instance, the official propaganda is that Kim Jong Un, the new guy, that he's in there. I remember saw one of these documentaries about they opened up a new health fitness thing, and that it was Kim Jong Un who came in there and personally inspected all of the fitness equipment.
They have little red plaques on the stuff
that he inspected.
And people don't use the equipment that doesn't have the red plaque.
Right, but I'm sure there was some, you know, private company or people that went in, inspected it first, and they're like, okay, just look at these ones. And he'll just walk over there and
That's
pretend
exactly
like he knows
right.
what he's doing. You know, put on a nice
if
show.
If they make a show of it at all, yeah. rather than just making the claim. Well, yes, it was the deer leader who inspected all of this. Because they also claim that the deer leader designed the entire facility as well. He's an architect.
And the workout routine.
Right. Yeah. And,
so
and
that there's
airplanes
the certain...
were invented not so long ago either.
Yeah, yeah there's the certain
By
routine.
The deer leader.
Right.
There's the certain routine where you use all of the equipment that he inspected mm-hmm. and you use it in sort of a rotation, and that is the best workout right. because that was deer leader's workout.
They'll probably give you whippings if you don't do the deer leader workout, but I'm speculating
or
on that one.
Or they'll just be like, oh, well, I mean...
You don't love you the deer leader as much as I do.
You must not be, you know, as good at working out. You must just be lazy.
Have you guys ever seen the footage, and I think it might have been the same documentary, where they go into one of these show stores?
Yes.
No.
It's so creepy. They have these stores that are sort of made to appear as though they're like a department store. They have products in stock, but they don't actually sell anything to anyone average. I guess they will like make a sale to a tourist or something like that, but the average North Korean folk cannot go into these stores and purchase products.
Wow,
and there's
weird.
Only like one or two items deep.
Right, on
where
the shelf.
Normally the shelves they'll have it, you know, like all the way back.
Right. Well,
they've got like one or two.
Right, it's like a cardboard display of, you know, like the
it's
mountains and trees in the background.
Okay.
Well, yeah, I'm just saying, like, it looks like it could be real, but yeah. it's not really. But I've heard, you know, like reporters will go to North Korea after going through this long approval process where, mm-hmm. like, their whole trip is planned out. So they don't get many tourists, so they don't really need to, you know, put a lot of effort into the show that they're putting on. But they've got, like, pre-planned routes, and
yes.
they keep, you know, they keep all of the natives from talking to these people because then they'll find out about like the death camps and there's like prisons where they will send you if you turn against the leader in some
Absolutely.
Way.
They will send
and,
you if your second cousin turns against
That's
dear
true.
Leader.
And they keep your children there as well. Like
yes.
it's crazy. It's multi-generational.
Three generations.
So yeah, there's a lot of crazy in North Korea.
There was a good documentary that was done by National Geographic. Some years ago
in the 90s
where they went in with a medical crew
mm-hmm.
and the medical crew they were doing cataract surgeries on people and they were filming the like removal of the bandages from these people after having their cataracts done and the people were going up and bowing to the picture of the deer leader and praising the deer leader for the surgery that the doctor did.
Had provided.
But he gave the technology for the surgery, right?
Probably.
And the camera crew was able to sneak in to one of the houses of one of the people, and all of the pictures on the wall were pictures of deer leader and of Kim Jong-il.
I wouldn't want to look at those faces all day. Ugh.
And... So Lisa Ling, who was the reporter that snuck in with the crew, she asked one of the people, she said, which one is your favorite picture of Dear Leader? Oh, they're all my favorite.
all equally. I love them as much.
Can Dear Leader do anything wrong? And the response was, I don't understand your question.
Yeah, it's outside their paradigm. Toll-free number, 855-450-FREE. I don't know how we ended up getting off on North Korea, but the point was, I'm sure
monopolies.
The socialists would say, well, they're doing it wrong. Just put me in charge, or my favorite socialist, and
everybody's
then it'll be a
little
paradise.
Tyrant.
855-450-FREE, because force is a great idea.
Angioprim can unclog blocked arteries and improve blood flow in all parts of your body. Angioprim is oral chelation. Easy, simple, liquid oral chelation. You take it with juice before breakfast and forget about it. Angioprim works fast, unlike old-fashioned chelation that takes hours. Just log on to angioprim.com. That's Angioprim, A-N-G-I-O-P-R-I-M, angioprim.com. Angioprim users say they have more energy, more strength, more endurance. Increased circulation and blood flow will make all your body parts work better. Log on to angioprim.com.
Trim.com to get more information on how you can get started and start feeling better, having fun, and doing more again. Lots more. Talk to a trained AngioPrim consultant. Call AngioPrim toll-free at 877-882-7221. That's 877-882-7221. Or log on for complete information. AngioPrim.com. That's AngioPrim.com. Find out how AngioPrim can work for you. Get the facts about AngioPrim at AngioPrim.com.
Adam Miller here with Midas Resources. Today, August 29th, 2014, gold opened at $1,287.60. A 1 ounce gold coin can be purchased for $1,334.47, $667.23 for a half ounce, or $333.62 for a quarter ounce. That's $1,334.47, $667.23, and $333.62.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? Wait a sec. Gold and silver is going up while Congress is trying to settle on the next debt increase. And there's no end to this madness. That old 401k and IRA can be converted into physical gold without tax consequences. I explained this in my book, 10 Reasons to Buy Gold. Don't let time slip away. Call for your free copy today, 800-686-2237. Get away from that Washington spin and get honest answers about gold. 800-686-2237. The book is free, 800-686-2237.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the Road to Freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
You can interact with other LRN listeners in our message board at forum.lrn.fm. That's forum.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll free and bring up anything you want here at 855 450 free. Whether you want to discuss government-run healthcare, North Korea, or whatever happens to be on your mind, we're here for you. And the we is me, Ian.
Alan.
And Daryl.
And those phone lines are brought to you by ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network, and you can go and get signed up for free at proxpn.com/FTL. The first thing they're going to do for you is encrypt your internet connection, and that means that your internet service provider, after you've encrypted with ProXPN, will no longer know what you're doing online. They're probably logging every website you visit now, and they're probably logging every search term you enter. So in some cases, they're keeping those logs up to 5 years at your internet service provider, which means it's easy for law enforcement or any government agency to access. Maybe they're even selling your information to other companies. Who knows? But you can stop that from happening. All that data collection, stop it right now by going to proxpn.com/FTL. Download their software. It's available for Windows, Macintosh, iOS devices, or Android devices. Linux users, you can also use ProXPN. Its setup's a little bit different for you. Go to proxpn.com/FTL It's great privacy protection. Plus, when you upgrade to their premium account, you'll get unlimited bandwidth. You'll get servers around the world you can connect to. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. That's presuming you're in a country that you can get internet access. I don't know if it's going to help you in North Korea because you don't really get internet there.
They're not really listening to this show in North Korea either.
I just meant if you were going to travel there or something like that. If you're traveling, ProXPN's a really useful thing to have. If you're in different countries that have restrictions, they can help you get around those restrictions. So proxpn.com/FTL. Use this code to get 50% off the price of the annual account. Code is FTL, like Free Talk Live, FTL50. It's all one word, FTL50. And then there's also a Bitcoin discount, which will get you 62% off the annual account. By the way, these discounts are good for the lifetime of your account. The Bitcoin discount is FTLBTC, like Bitcoin. So go and grab your free account right now at proxpn.com/FTL and get started. And then upgrade when you're ready with code FTL50 or FTLBTC to get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Let's go to Habu, listening in Madison, Wisconsin. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian, Ellen, and Daryl.
Well, thank you for the opportunity. This is my favorite lineup in your studio there.
Oh, great.
I'm listening to your last segment, and you were talking about North Korea and the people there. Mm-hmm. And yes, these people kind of worship that leader. But, you know, let me just say this. There are, of course, this is your own talk show, and you can talk of many, many things. There are other things which are much more troubling on the horizon, and I'm talking about polls have shown that the majority of Americans are in favor of bombing ISIS. And, you know, that means they couldn't do in Syria last year, they're going to do this year. Oh. I have no animus towards the people in North Korea. They haven't killed millions and zillions as the American government has. And,
well, we don't know how many North Koreans have been killed by North Koreans. I mean, that's a number that's going to be very hard to get.
But it certainly doesn't touch what America has killed around the world.
There's a good argument on that one. I mean, there's no doubt about that.
Yeah, so let's not escape it. So, North Korea is a hideous example of what goes wrong when it becomes so totalitarian. But what's even worrying is when a democracy morphs into this monster that, you know, you talk about every other day, whether it's police or going and bombing other countries.
Oh, absolutely.
So
we had a discussion on the air once upon a time, and I think it's an interesting question, is who is the worst tyrant? I mean, is it Barack Obama or Kim Jong-un? Because, you know, as you pointed out, the American presidents are responsible for destroying millions upon millions of lives worldwide. And in North Korea, yeah, he's a little tyrant, but he's only a tyrant over his own little domain, not over the entire world. So it's very interesting kind of comparing the two and trying to decide who is the bigger tyrant and in which different ways. But go ahead with your points.
Well, just real quick, you had said that it's bad when a democracy turns into a monster. And I would say that by definition, democracies are monsters because democracies allow the majority or in most cases, the plurality of people to wind up, you know, foisting their will upon everyone else.
Right, but he's making a good point here, I think, is that, you know, North Korea, although it is very destructive in the fact that it has this totalitarianist government, it's only committing these atrocities to people within the country. It's not going outside of its bounds and, you know, throwing bombs at people like the U.S. has the capability and the riches to do.
Right.
Habu, go ahead.
Well, I think the young lady said it correctly and said it in fewer words than I did. But anyway, so this is a troubling issue, meaning that we are so scared out of our boots because of ISIS or, you know, the propaganda from the mainstream media, not yours, of course, but the propaganda, and it is really driving Americans batty. This is the way, wasn't there a very famous saying that, you know, when fascism comes into the country, it'll come on the backs of democracy?
It'll come waving a flag. I forget it was who
yeah,
was
of course.
That said that.
And that's the same thing that's going to happen now. This is going to even and this is of course the last consideration, but an important one. It is going to impoverish us. Already we are in in penury thanks to two wars that were not necessary, let alone all the bad will it has engendered, and bad will around the world against the U.S. So, and what it has set in motion, which is even more problematic, the whole regions have become unstable. So, these are not because I say it, but these I think are worthy points. And yes, I don't care that you make fun of anybody for, of course, valid reasons as you have, but in the end, we should never lose sight of the ball. Meaning, what are we going to do next? What more havoc are we going to wreak around the world? So that's all, and thank you very much.
Well,
for
it's
the
not
courtesy.
So much, and Abu, we totally agree. I mean, on this show, I'm against war, and I think every co-host on the show is against war, and we've certainly talked a lot about what's going on in the Middle East and various conflicts. So thank you, I appreciate that. When we're talking about North Korea, it's only funny in an uncomfortable way. Like, you're only laughing because it's so scary and so crazy. And I think that it's instructive to talk about some of the worst of the world in order to know that ultimately what we're talking about is really just a difference in degrees. Yeah, they've got prison camps in North Korea, and yeah, they'll put your family members in there. But the United States is locking up more people around in the U.S. than, what is it, the rest of the world combined or something crazy like that?
One out of four prisoners in the world is an inmate in a jail or prison in the United States.
Yeah. So, I mean, around here, there's a good chance your family members are getting locked up here too. And again, it's just a difference in degrees as far as the level of tyranny that goes on in North Korea.
Right.
In
the full-on myrrh worshipping hasn't, occurred yet. Like, we're not making offerings
extent.
And
bowing
down to pictures.
That's true, but there are people who have sung songs to Barack Obama.
Yeah, there's people who buy into him completely.
There was the one news reporter that said that I had chills roll up my leg when he walked in the room.
People in this country will voluntarily. I was in, my ex-girlfriend, her grandparents had a picture of George Bush hanging in their bathroom. It was like an autographed picture of George and Laura Bush. 855-450-FREE. No one put a gun to their head and put that in there. It's Free Talk Live.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
We've been patiently waiting. Waiting while you tried to ignore us. Waiting while you acted like we didn't exist. Waiting for our chance to be taken seriously. The wait is over. GCN is available 24/7 at GCNlive.com. Navigate through news from your favorite hosts and download archives of past shows. Download the app on your smartphone or tablet or visit GCNlive.com for instant access and live streaming. GCNlive.com, the future of talk radio. Now at your fingertips.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com.
Have you ever wanted to help a hardworking person get their business off the ground? Then join me in enjoying some BuzzBox coffee. Let's make a difference, one cup at a time. Join us in helping people buy their own coffee farms through at least 100 microloans via World Vision. Free Talk Live coffee drinkers will truly change lives forever. To get the best coffee you've ever tasted, it's organic, shade grown, and top 1% Arabica grade. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. The first pound's free, just cover shipping.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Well, George, you can go this way.
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring Simon to their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me. Hey.
Who do you think you
excuse
are?
Excuse me.
There is no video and audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make...
Wait, you go. Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared of me!
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, the show where you can take control of the airwaves. Bring up anything you want. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. And as usual, you know, we've had the intention of sharing this Seven Strange Libertarian Ideas article, and we really haven't gotten past the first sentence of number one, which is parents should be allowed to let their children starve to death. And I'm hoping we will get a chance to talk about this. The we tonight includes me, Ian.
Alan.
And Daryl.
Let's jump back into your phone calls first, however. Oh, and I want to remind you, we were just talking about this during the break, Daryl. Keenvention is coming up. Keenvention.info is the website. In fact, literally just moments before the show started tonight, I posted a brand new post over on the Keenvention website at keenvention.info announcing the Cop Block panel for Keenvention 2014. Now, Keenvention's coming up October 31st. That's right, Halloween night. And through November 2nd, also recently announced for Keenvention is a Halloween night party, a costume party thrown by our very own Derek J. Freeman, which I'm excited about. So that's something that we didn't have last year, so we'll be doing that this year for the first time. The Cop Block panel is also new for 2014. Cop Block radio host Eric Freerock is going to be heading it up, and it's actually the first full panel that we've announced. We've been announcing panel hosts, like the moderators, up until this point. This one is the first full panel. So Joel Valenzuela, who's a relatively new mover and very active mover out in the Manchester area, Riaz Kahan or Kahan, I honestly don't know how to pronounce his last name, but a super cool guy, super activist out in the Manchester area. He's going to be on the panel, and Centurion from Cop Block will also be on the panel. So I'm excited about it.
Oh, that'll be interesting.
Yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun, and the activism in the Cop Block sphere up here in New Hampshire this year has been busier than ever. I mean, New Hampshire's always been a good place for Cop Block activities, and of course, copblock.org was basically founded founded in New Hampshire. The founders have lived in, the founders do live in New Hampshire, and both of the founders have lived in Keene, and one of them is currently living right outside of Keene. So Cop Block is a long history here, and so it's going to be great to have a Cop Block panel. We'll talk, I'm sure, about the Manchester DUI checkpoint activism that has gone on basically every 2 weeks, they've had 30 or 40 activists out there on the streets in Manchester doing DUI checkpoint cop blocking. In fact, that's what's happening tonight. There's actually a carload or two of keen activists heading out to Manchester tonight to assist with the Manchester cop blocking. But I'll be staying in town, and I'll be heading out to the college neighborhood a little bit later on tonight. And we're doing Don't Take a Plea Deal, or not Don't Take a Plea, we're doing Know Your Rights outreach in the college neighborhoods. And cop block's having an impact here. And it can have an impact in a place where there's a lot of people together, which is what we're doing in New Hampshire. The Free State Project is bringing liberty activists all to the same place. That place is New Hampshire. And Keenvention is your opportunity to check out New Hampshire during the fall, again, October 31st through November 2nd, and focus on activism while you're here. There's a great convention the Free State Project puts on called the Liberty Forum, which happens in the wintertime, and that's an awesome event. But the Liberty Forum and, to a lesser extent, Porkfest, which is their other event, their summertime event, the Porcupine Freedom Festival, these events, they bring in outside speakers. There's big names, celebrity speakers within the libertarian movement that they bring in for these other events. Keenvention, we don't bring anybody in from outside to speak at the event. You're welcome to come in from the outside and attend the event and participate as an attendee, ask questions and, you know, things like that. But actually on stage, the focus, the featured speakers that we have, the panelists, they're all activists based in New Hampshire, because that's what I wanted Keenvention to focus on, was the activism scene here, because we've got an amazing scene. You can go to keenvention.info, go grab your tickets there. They're just $60 for the entire weekend, which for a convention is a pretty unbelievable price. You get a special discount on the hotel rooms, which are also affordable. So keenvention.info, go there, learn more. You can also watch past videos from last year and kind of get a feel for what the event was like.
And you can use Bitcoin.
Thank you for the reminder. That's right, $60 through Eventbrite, which is major credit cards, or Bitcoin over at keenvention.info. And Daryl, you were a big help last year, helped out with kind of printing up the flyers that were distributed at the event. You actually ran a raffle, which you're bringing back.
Yes.
Any idea what you'll be raffling yet?
Not entirely sure. I do have a friend that lives down in the Atlanta area that makes chainmail.
That's unique.
She will make a bracelet or two to be raffled off.
Chainmail's pretty cool, man. I used to have a roommate who would make chainmail, and you can literally jab a knife at somebody wearing that stuff, and it won't hurt them. It's pretty neat. All right, let's go to the phones here. You can take control of the airwaves. We go to Dave. He's in Long Island. Dave, you're on Free Talk Live.
How you doing?
Hey, Dave.
How's everything?
Yeah, what's on your mind tonight?
Good. No, I was just, you know, I know it's the same old thing, you know, I used to this, that, you know, Joan Rivers. But, you know, like, if we get down to the reality of what's going on, you know, this side of our world has been trying to take over the world since modern-day Persia, you know, Syria, like Iran. This is a plan they've had for thousands of years. It's
Who's had what plan?
Well, you know, like, that side, the East, you know, talking about Iran, modern-day Iran. For instance, you know what I mean? That's Persia. That's modern-day Persia.
Well, every side of the world is trying to take over every other side. It's not just the East specifically.
But if you're in America, I'm just talking from an American state of mind. If you're on the American side and people are with all the controversies and conspiracies, of course they're there. Of course we bomb people. Of course we do things that casualties are, you know, that must be taken for a better half of man, you know? It's things that
no, it's not
done,
better. You know? It's not bettering man to bomb people. What are you talking about?
I didn't say to bomb people.
I'm sorry. I thought that's what you said.
No. But I'm saying if people are going to, if you're saying bomb, if you're saying people are going to threaten you at your doorstep, how would you react to them?
Well, there's nobody threatening me at my doorstep except for the state police.
No, I'm saying, look, let's say if you were in their circumstance, you lived in Iraq, in Mosul, you live in some of these areas where they're, you know, the Muslims are killing the Muslims. It's not even the Christians. They're trying to find Christians to kill. They can't. So they're killing their own people, and they're saying, well, it's because Allah told me to do it.
What is your question? I don't understand what you're asking me. How would I feel if there were people killing people where I live? I'd feel terrible about that. There are people killing people in the United States, and that's a bad thing, and it doesn't matter what their religion is.
No, I didn't actually want to ask like a question. I just wanted to like discuss, you know, get a couple of points on how you guys.
I don't know what
that.
Your point is,
and
though. That's the problem.
Think?
I'm very confused. I don't know about the rest of you, the studio.
Oh, I'm super confused.
Well, because like it's really confusing because it's like.
Well, because you're all over the place.
Well, let's just erase everything that's happened with this whole little group, and let's I'm just taking you as far as the debate.
One Erase everything that's happened with what group?
Do you think it's more of a blue and red state over here, like the Democrats?
Over where?
Over where we live. Now, everything
you're in New York.
Over there. Yeah, I know, but listen. Just listen to what I'm saying. Give me 1 minute to explain to you. Now, everything's going on in the world. Everybody's up to date. Everybody knows what's going on the panel. I'm sure everybody watches news and reads articles, and they see the, you know, things that are going on. Now, as far as, like, in our country, just at the end of my thing, I'm trying to get to it, now it's becoming the Democrats are, you know, having a battle in Nebraska and Virginia. A lot of things are going on where it's like almost like the Democrats are trying to take over the United States, and it's like a red and blue state more than it's like, you know. Cause it's
yeah, I have no idea what you're saying. I really have no idea. Ellen, are you able to understand what Dave is getting at here?
I think
no
what
clue.
he's trying to say is that there's one specific group of people. I believe he's claiming it's the Democrats that they're trying to take over the U.S. with their belief system and enforce their laws.
That's just not going to happen. I mean, there are different states that are Republican controlled that have no, you know, the Democrats have no chance of taking those states over.
Doesn't every group try to do that? And depending on what side you're on, you're going to think, the other side's trying to take us over.
The Republicans would love to take over all the states
every
too.
Every group,
they can't
but
do it
libertarians.
Either. Right, and these guys are going to be fighting over
the but
the
it's
controls.
Just confusing because they're still trying to get voted in. Like, they're using the system that exists to try to destroy the system.
I don't think anyone's trying to destroy the system within the system. Dave, thanks for the call. Sounds like you're having some trouble with your phone, and besides, I can't understand really what you're saying anyway.
Well, I don't mean, like, totally destroy. I just mean libertarians want to get into politics so that they can remove a lot of, like, laws and fees and legislation that don't make sense.
Oh, you're talking about the libertarians.
Yes.
I see.
Yeah, because I said the libertarians are the only ones that aren't trying to control the world.
Well, it's a general statement. I think there are a lot of people who get into libertarian politics because they see it as a way to have some level of control over some sort of a political system, like, you know, people like Bob Barr. That guy's not a real libertarian.
I meant real libertarians.
More coming up here in moments. This is Free Talk Live.
I want to share something important that will not only improve your life, but the lives of many others as well. And all you need to do is drink coffee. I'm not talking about harmful store-bought or chain coffee. No, this is truly the best of the best coffee. We've partnered with Camano Island Coffee Roasters to offer BuzzBox. With every purchase, 10% goes towards our efforts to give the gift of human freedom by providing at least 100 microfinance loans via World Vision. So literally, just one cup at a time, you're having an impact and helping make a difference in the world. And one sip will have you buzzing to family and friends. To prove just how good it is, we're giving a free pound of coffee to everyone in the audience. All you do is cover shipping. Go to coffee.freetalklive.com. BuzzBox Coffee is organic, so it contains no pesticides or toxins. It's shade grown, so less acidity and no heartburn. It's top 1% Arabica grade and gives people the opportunity to own their own coffee farms. Join us in making a huge impact at coffee.freetalklive.com.
Summertime is save big time at Herbal Healer Academy. Long-term customers know summer is the time to stock up at herbalhealer.com. And for new customers, welcome to the web's best place to save on vitamins, minerals, and more. Log on for summer specials, including all sizes of colloidal silver, colloidal minerals, and intestinal freedom on sale. Choose from Herbal Healer's great variety of weight loss products like apple cider vinegar, Hoodia, and Metabolic Complex and Pro-Metabolic, all on sale now. Also, the anti-parasite Intestinal Freedom and Wormwood Plus Complex, plus Stevia Liquid Sweetener and the Super Enzymes, all on sale for summer at herbalhealer.com. As always, we offer certificate correspondence courses in natural medicine. Enjoy same-day shipping and free online newsletter. Log on now to herbalhealer.com and look for summer specials to save big with our nation's leader in supplying quality natural medicine and education since 1988, Herbal Healer Academy.
Negotiation isn't just something union leaders and sports agents do. Your entire day is a series of negotiations. If you have young children, you know that. In fact, your kids can teach you a lot about negotiating with grown-ups. According to the world's greatest negotiator, Herb Cohen, author of You Can Negotiate Anything. Herb says that kids understand the process of decision-making within an organization. organization. When one parent says no, they'll ask the other. And Cohen says children persist and persevere. And like smart negotiators of all ages, kids know that no is an opening bargaining position. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. For more tips, hit survivalspeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com.
Ross Ulbricht was arrested by the FBI in 2013 and charged with victimless crimes in relation to allegedly operating the Bitcoin-based Silk Road black market. He has been in a prison cell awaiting trial ever since. If he did it, he's a hero for making the black market a safer place. If he did not, he's a man wrongfully accused. Either way, if you love freedom and want to end the war on drugs, Ross and his family need your support. You can learn more and help fund his defense at FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
Talk Live. Take control of the airwaves and dial toll-free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online. Visit freetalklive.com. Get interactive on the site. And if you like the show and want to help support Free Talk Live, please become an amplifier. I mentioned earlier how Daryl is helping with affiliate relations and actually these days doing the bulk of it. He's doing a great job bringing new stations on board. In fact, the new station that we announced this week in Phoenix, KFNN, that's one of yours, Daryl, that you brought on. So thank you for that. But it's big thanks to the Free Talk Live amplifiers for helping pay for you, because otherwise, if it weren't for the AMP program, we wouldn't be able to afford your services. So the AMP program really makes it happen around here. It makes it so that new stations, new radio stations all around the United States, and hopefully eventually outside the United States, will come on board and take Free Talk Live, and hopefully we'll be able to entertain their listeners and stay on board. We've got over 160 stations so far, and we're going to get more with your help. If you become a Free Talk Live amplifier, you can do that over at amp.freetalklive.com. That's amp.freetalklive.com. And when you become an amplifier, it's a very simple process. You can use any major credit card through PayPal, or you can use Visa or MasterCard right there on the front page of the website. Or not the front page, but over at amp.freetalklive.com. And makes it easy, and it makes a big difference for us when you do that. So thank you in advance. You get perks. You get deals like, or special perks like the AMP-only phone lines, the AMP-only forum, the AMP-only Facebook group, and more. So go and learn more and get signed up, please, at amp.freetalklive.com. Frankie is in Chicago. You're on Free Talk Live. Frankie.
Hi, how you doing?
Great. Go ahead with your thoughts, Frankie.
Good, good. What do you think as far as, not just a question, but it's kind of a statement I'm making? Ukraine, all that kind of stuff going on. Somalia, you got the Iraq, you got the Syria problems. Meanwhile, they were in the government right now. They're going to court for war crimes. Who are we going to be helping here? Who are we going to be helping here? Kind of like we can't help anybody. It's kind of like we got to go in there and just clean house. It's not up. What do you think about that?
Who's going to go clean house and where?
Well, somebody has to clean house and go, you know, take out these infidels, don't you think?
What do you mean by clean house?
Is this just sort of this obtuse caller night as far as the last two segments have gone? You're being very nebulous with what you're saying. Are you saying that you want the U.S. military to go into certain Middle Eastern countries and exterminate people? Is that what you're saying?
No. I'm trying to see what kind of border patrols. Also, what do you think? I'm trying to get your guys' information. What do you guys? Because
It sounded like you were talking about other countries there for a moment and cleaning house. Now you're talking about border patrols?
There's so many issues we could talk about.
Why don't you pick one?
Let me see here. One would be, whose side are we going to pick? Like, how does
I'm not picking anyone's side. Why do I have to pick a side?
So what do you do then? I don't understand. Like, what do you do? Just watch it on the news?
Watch what on the news?
Remember, I'm just a regular guy sitting and watching this. I just came across your radio show.
Well, so a lot of people are going to choose one side or the other and be like, oh, I agree with this point or I agree with that side. But they're not going to be going out from their houses, taking a plane, going to whatever country they support and, like, arming up just to support that cause. Like, that's not what people do.
I'm not interested in supporting the killing of people around the world, and I'm not interested in supporting the imprisoning of people within this country. So that should make it pretty clear what my position is. What's yours, Frankie?
I get you, because politically that's how you stand. I'm sorry. Well, I'm looking at it more as like a humanitarian thing. People are dying right now. You know,
well, you don't go and solve humanitarian problems by killing more humans, do you?
Oh, but it's not. I didn't say the word killing. See, you keep on putting words in my mouth. I meant religiously also, because this is also so-called
a
religion.
Oh, I'm sorry. When you say things like clean house or whatever, that sort of has the flavor of exterminating populations. So what would you like to see happen over in the Middle East or at the border or whichever issue you want to pick? Go ahead.
It's not what I would like to see.
Yes, it is. That's why I asked you.
From watching media and watching news and all kinds of stuff, I kind of have an inclination that from what's going on and, you know, the media, how the media plays into it and how they're popping up with different areas in the world, like Somalia.
Who's popping up with different areas of the world?
Do you watch the news? Do you watch the news?
Hell no. Who's popping up? You said someone's popping up. They are popping up. Who is they?
I'm sorry. You know what it is? I'm thinking that you watch the news like I do. And
yeah, I don't watch television. I don't even have television. Do you guys watch the news?
No, I read a lot of news, but I don't watch the news.
The problem is, Frankie, if we can't communicate, we can't have a conversation. And so far, your call has been very hard to understand. When you say they are popping up in other countries, what do you mean?
I've been doing a lot of research on, like, I'm watching the news, and I'm like, okay, how much is this real? You know, because sometimes I've watched, like, let's say, for instance, the Discovery Channel, Nat Geo, which is supposed to be credible information for young individuals. Then I come to find out that they're making documentaries that are absolutely fake, but to the naked eye.
Thanks, Frankie, for the call tonight. Sounds like you're all over the place, just like our last caller. I don't know if there's, like, a club of people who can't communicate.
I think it was the same person calling under two different
names.
That
call was on. There was two calls were on hold at the same time. I suppose he could have had two phone lines open.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's go to Nathan in Texas. Nathan, can you make sense? Go ahead.
I hope so.
Okay,
so
good. I hope it's not something in the water or a full moon or something like that.
Nathan generally makes sense.
Yes, that's why I was hoping that he would be able to make sense. If Nathan is not making sense, then something is really wrong.
And yeah.
Go ahead.
Right, then you'll know it's time to retreat to the concrete bunkers.
Yeah.
So,
well, at least you admit it.
So Liberty Phoenix called in earlier this week talking about trying to convince other people about the ideas of liberty, and I wanted to recommend a podcast that the Bad Quaker did in 2012 with Dave McElroy. He's a political consultant, and he in the interview he talks about how, as a political consultant, people are just not interested in the ideas of liberty for the most part. You know, you'll have like a 40% Republican, 40% Democrats. And then, you know, the ads and such will focus on convincing the independents to one side or the other. And generally, libertarian candidates don't get very much pull.
That's true.
David McElroy did a very brilliant little short film a few years ago called We're the Government and You're Not.
Oh, that was him? Okay, I've seen that.
Yes.
Yeah, that was pretty funny.
He also wrote some articles talking about why Ron Paul won't ever be elected. And I guess I should apologize. It's probably maybe too cynical for Liberty Phoenix, but I thought I'd recommend it because it shows the opposite viewpoint. Instead of talking about convincing people, he evinces the viewpoint that once he gave up trying to convince people of liberty, he was a lot happier because it's not that he doesn't write or speak, but rather he thinks of what he does as discovering people who already agree with him.
No, that's a good point, actually, because when I was younger, I used to try to do that. I'd be like really combative with my viewpoints. Like, what? You don't believe in this liberty thing? Like, what is your problem?
Anywhere, right?
No, it didn't. So it really is a much better strategy if you just get to know people and try to understand them. And then, you know, like, you'll find that they do have, you know, certain things that they agree with you on. And then you can, you know, open their mind up more because they're more accepting of you.
It's a long road. There's no doubt about that. And being patient with people works a lot better. Mm-hmm.
And there's a couple of really good videos on YouTube of how not to talk to people about the ideas of liberty, one of which actually was produced by some members of the Libertarian Party, where they went around to different Libertarian Party outreach booths, like the Operation Politically Homeless that you said that you've done. And they had people that knew how to do the booth. But they told them, like, you know, just do the absolute worst job that you can. And they were catching it. But they were only filming them do this to Confederates. So people that, you know, were also libertarians that would walk up. And some of it is just so funny.
Because it's so true.
But it's one of those things of where you're like, oh, yeah, I know somebody that's exactly like that.
Wait, so
I'd like if you could link to that video. I'd very much like to see
that. Oh, yeah, I'll find those and link them on the Free Talk Live Facebook page.
Are they, like, yelling at these people, so you want to go kill innocent civilians?
Yeah, that's certainly a bad tactic.
What do you mean you don't like guns? You have to like guns. Here's all the guns I've got.
All right. Hey, Nathan, thanks for the call, man. I appreciate it. And, of course, we've mentioned before the Advocates for Self-Government is an excellent organization that helps liberty-minded people become better communicators of these ideas. Because ultimately, this is what we have to do. We have to propagate the ideas of freedom. And if we can be more efficient or more compassionate towards the people that we're talking to, be better at communicating those ideas, then maybe they'll be more likely to come on sooner rather than later, even though, again, it is a long road. Which is why moving together with liberty-minded people who are already on board makes a lot of sense. So go and check out freestateproject.org and check out Daryl's website, fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc. And we'll see you tomorrow night online. In the meantime, freetalklive.com. Tomorrow, Adam Kokesh is going to be on the show.
Woohoo!
America. Free Talk Live.
I don't believe in homosexuality.
Should homosexuality be outlawed, Rita?
I think not only homosexuality, but prostitution and fornication.
Fornication?
Are
you going to pass
sir.
Laws against people masturbating?
I beg your pardon, sir.
Would you pass laws against people masturbating, ma'am?
I'm very much offended that you would ask me such a question.
What, you can't answer
like
a simple question? Would you pass
sir,
a law against people masturbating?
Sir, I
mean, you want to pass laws against two men having sex. I'm just asking you a question.
She said she wanted to pass law against fornication. That's just anybody
That's
having
anybody
sex.
Having sex.
Okay, Rita, let's say I have a fiancé and you overheard us having sex. Would you report us to the cops if there was a law against fornication?
You darn right, sir.
Yeah? How dare you?
How dare
you? Who do you think you are?
How dare you, sir? Who do you
How
think you are?
How dare I have sex with a consenting adult
on my own
you're
property?
You're a moral reprobate, and you're one of the ones who are helping to disintegrate this country.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM. 35% of U.S. credit accounts are facing collection agencies. Of that 35, almost 40% are the result of medical bills. Before uninsured friends or family go in for medical treatment, send them to AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com. No computer tracing, no tracking cookies. They will not go on a list. Privacy matters. Just tell us what you need. Get a quote. Fractions of U.S. prices. AsiaRunLikeHellGuide.com.